Me too.
Alright. Yeah, senpai. Yeah, senpai.
You text me this morning? No, before I left, I texted her.
Oh, so just today?
Yeah. And then I did not expect her to be so gay. Because it was supposedly a measuring stick.
Yeah. Well, it definitely
paid off.
Paid off. That's a big hint.
That's real-life D10 inspiration.
Bardic inspiration.
Alright. So, to recap, you were all passengers, crew, and explorers, and scholars that have joined Eiderback Rainer's expedition to the fabled Sky Kingdom of Aretea. You've taken an airship to Aretea in the hopes of exploring, discovering, and coming back with many finds. New finds, either magical, technological, or historical finds that perhaps might shed some light on this Sky Kingdom which has disappeared. It's an island in the middle of the sky. Unfortunately, en route, you were attacked by a notorious group of pirates led by Valvorex Skysbane on the capstone. Yes, the capstone. On the capstone, her flagship. Fortunately, you were able to rebel the borders and Valvorex herself, but significant damage was done to the ship itself, and you had to make an emergency crash landing upon Aretea. You found yourself stranded the chief engineer Umbratis reported that the significant damage was done to the ship's engine. So Umbratis led a party of individuals forward to seek out a mysterious artifact power source from whatever RKO tech exists upon Aretea. We begin our story before they come back. On the first day of their adventure, perhaps they just haven't left. Let's go around the table just for a short introduction. Name, race, class, and background, and maybe a little bit something about yourself that you want to reveal. If you have certain things hidden, that's okay. You can do that. Where is my notebook? And my...
This one? This one here. Hmm? Oh, right. Your notebook's in there already.
If you would like to... If you have secret motives or whatever, I only know of the ones that have already been given to me. So if you have any new ones, you can go ahead and slip me a note or whatever. Otherwise, we know only what you reveal to us now. Let's start with Hav, since he might be the most well thought of already.
So, my character's name is Dodger D. Best. The D in his name means stands for Dillinger. serving as first mate on the ship, you're not exactly sure of his motives, but you know that from the look of him, he's been on a few ships, but he doesn't look like he was built for this. Like, he doesn't look like he's been doing this his whole life. It seems like this is something that he's doing now as a means to an end.
How do you like to be referred to?
Dodger.
No, I refuse.
Fine, then Bast.
Call you first mate.
The first mate and the second mate have been relatively close throughout this expedition. They seem to have been working on some sort of secret project between the two of them. First mate Dodger and the second mate Grado. They've been keeping it hush hush and not really been involving many of the other crew members. Just between them, it seems If you were just to make just an observation, you would suspect that perhaps it would be a personal errand of either the Griddle or the anything else? You look? You guess?
So,
any powers that you've already revealed or none?
Will you run the ship? Other than the fact that
when you were repelling pirates, you could have revealed something about yourself.
Not really that, but prior to that, during the ship's voyage itself, and people who served alongside him on other occasions, will note that he can always tell whether you're in your room or not. And for some godforsaken reason, whenever he wants to, he can find you.
Okay.
Physically, he looks like this.
Oh, Assassin's Creed.
Yeah. Very. He wears rather thick robes with a strange patch on the side. It might be representative of a rank or station. Aside from that, he seems rather lithe. Toned, but then not too overly muscular, and he seems to prioritize elegance.
Elegance. Let's go on to the movie.
I am Saros Ashford with an X. So Saros Ashford. Saros Ashford. I am a human.
I thought it was Saros Ashford X.
I'm a researcher. I am a researcher. An up-and-coming historian of Aratean lore, actually. One might call me the rising rock star of the industry,
okay.
if such a thing were a thing.
Okay.
And I secretly bought a ticket to the Lysias in order to get into Aratea myself, in the hopes under the guise of a tourist.
Okay.
And right now I am freaking the fuck out because I did not expect pirates and I did not expect combat, but I'm still not gonna go home empty-handed.
Mm-hmm.
And he has long hair and a serious look on his face, but that's really the only intimidating thing about him.
Sorry. Oh, okay.
Because
is that not elf?
Not elf.
Is it?
No, it's probably an like plastic ears or something.
You could say that was part of the disguise.
Saros.
I'm not even an elf!
Saros has learned blade singing from the northern elven tribes.
Alright.
Although when you see him try it, it's not particularly as good as what you might have heard.
Mm.
And you might even be disappointed with when he tries to perform it.
Okay.
But otherwise, he is proficient at it, and he knows his way around a fight, though as much as possible, he'd like not to get in the face.
Did he help out to repel the borders?
Yeah, he did. Though, once this area was clear, he did not move towards other areas to help out.
Okay. Tell me about Lysander Driston.
Lysander Driston is...
Oh, sorry, Lysander.
Earth Genasi. He looks middle-aged. He is on this trip for souls. He is a tourist, technically. He secured himself a ticket to journey to Aratea in honor of his wife, because she just died recently, and when she was alive, she loved magic and she loved to explore, and she mentioned several times about this place called Aratea. So
she loved her husband.
Mm-hmm. Yes, of course. Oh no, she just loved magic. He also helped out in holding back the pirates. He was surprised that there would. He wasn't surprised, I guess. He was a former sailor, but But after his wife died, he requested for some sort of
for
a leave for several months.
Okay. Are you serving as crew or passenger?
I'm just a passenger here.
Okay. But you're a sailor.
I'm a sailor. Alright. He's never worked in an airship, just the normal, just the usual sea ships.
So.
Why are you in the air?
You're like my Trident Barbarian.
Except he knows that he was getting on an airship.
But he's not serving it.
Yeah, he's not serving his crew. That's the primary difference, I think.
Yeah, I'm just here as a tourist.
Okay, alright. So when you begin, you're all assisting in whatever repairs can be made possible for the Lysaeus. Gathering wood to shore up damaged boards, trying to re-erect the mast. You can see that several more magically inclined individuals are spending hours and hours simply recasting men to try to heal back whatever the ship's damages can be possible. Everyone knows that without the primary engine, it's all useless. On the second day of your having been stranded after Bratis and the other who are the other characters that were present at that day?
Denahi, Bratis, and Ozzy.
Ozzy, Eiderbach, and went.
After their party went off. At around just approaching midday, a figure stumbles out of the tree line. The area that you've landed on, by the way, would somewhat be what passes for a beach, but there is no sand. It is simply an area, a clearing, previously uncleared, but forcibly cleared by the ship's entrance. That just sort of, perhaps maybe about 300 or so feet back, just falls off into the rest of the sky. Out from the tree line in front of you, in front of the ship, a figure stumbles out. Dodger, your first, or this is weird, Bast.
Huh?
I'm not used to calling my cat.
Oh, yeah.
That's why.
I'm
telling
cat.
You the Bast B Dodger on my list, so that I call you Bast instead.
Hey, what? That's fine too, that's fine. Dodger is the last name.
No. I'm just switching your name around so that my first, the first thing I see will be Bast. Okay, so.
Bastard.
Bastard.
Bast, an unfamiliar scent drifts by on the wind, and you raise your head immediately and catch the view of a ragged figure stumbling out of the tree line. It appears to be a woman, auburn hair. She is almost in rags. Upon closer inspection, they appear to be formerly fine clothes that have seen the wear and tear of what must be several traumatic experiences. What do you do?
Do I recognize her scent?
No, not at all. Unfamiliar. She's definitely not somebody that you smelled on the ship arriving.
That's creepy. Oh, I've never smelled her before.
I keep my hand on my rapier. I approach her with.
You get down from the ship.
Yeah, I get down. I get down. Before I get down from the ship, I call out to the captain and say,
"Sorry, I'm sorry."
I can't wait to try it. See you tomorrow.
What's that?
Nice. All the fuck yes.
Thank you.
I'm here with me.
Oh. Doki doki.
Anyway, I'm sorry.
I call out to the captain and say, Captain, we might have a situation. Captain, we might have a situation. And then with that...
situation? Midge armor!
I grab...
Are we like close to each other? Near each other?
Yeah. You can see that there's an upcoming commotion at the head of the ship.
After calling to the captain, I grab onto a rope. Make my way down, grab onto the rope, and then...
Slide down.
Sorry, how old are you?
Bast.
How old do you look like?
Roughly late 20s, early 30s.
How about you? Are you young?
I'm kind of youngish.
Okay.
But late 20s, early
30s. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
I keep my hand on my rapier. I keep my hand on my silver rapier.
Okay.
I approach with a blanket drawn, in one hand, with a blanket in one hand, and the silver rapier handle clutched on the other. And I approach her and I say, "Ma'am, are you okay?"
She seems barely on her feet, and she stumbles a few steps forward before finally collapsing onto the ground in front of you. She says, "Please, help my friends." And then,
I wrap her up in the blanket and I carry her princess style towards the ship, and I ask her, "What happened and where are your friends?"
With the help of some of the other crew members, you finally manage to wrangle her onto the ship. You lay her out on the deck, and Captain Rockface ushers everyone back. He says, "Get back to work, you bastards. She needs some air." You find yourself at the frontmost row of the remaining outlook.
Can I make a history check on her clothes? Maybe I can identify where it's from, perhaps?
Sure, okay.
That's 19.
It's a 61, not
20.
19
plus
5,
24.
24, okay. You can recognize just more than her clothes. This particular individual is actually familiar to you. She's fairly ragged, but the coat of arms on her... the coat of arms patch upon her clothing gives it away. She is Dr. Cecina Dirtry. Oh.
Cecina Dirtry?
Yes. The Dirtrys are historians as of you, but lesser known. But fairly stable, let's say. In the sense of, if you are an up-and-coming rock star,
the Owen Wilson,
then the Dirtrys have just always been there.
Okay,
and
like a stable presence
in history. Yeah, among the historians of your circle. The Dirtrys can be found far and wide, and though it is fairly surprising to see Cecina here of all places, as given Eiderback's excitement, you were under the impression that perhaps this would be the first to arrive, the first expedition to Aratea. Mm-hmm. But given that, you do actually recognize her, Cecina. You've attended some of her lectures, just to see how competent she might have been.
She is competent.
She's competent. Yeah.
Professor! Captain! This is actually Dr. Cecina Dirtry. She is actually a historian, not nearly as rock star as I am, but she is very competent in art and lore.
Captain Rockface says, "Bast, hand me the crew compliment."
Hand them the crew compliment.
So he looks through the crew compliment, he looks through the passenger list. Dirtry. I don't see a Dirty on this list.
Maybe she was here first. We can ask her. Give her some food first, if you will. Captain?
Right.
Dodger speaks out at this point.
He yells into one of those the pipes that
in the lower deck.
Bring some food up!
Dodger picks this moment to speak up, Princess.
I press the digitation her to clean her up.
Okay. her face cleans up and she becomes... her appearance gets a little closer to the scene of Dirty that you are familiar with.
Captain. I whisper to her, I call the captain aside and say, Captain, when I manage to...
Do you actually want to whisper it or...
No. Okay. It's just loud enough so that it won't cause panic among the general... Right. Among the general tourist population. Mm. I whisper to the captain and say, Captain, when we found her, she was asking for help for her friends. She said they might be in danger.
It's a dangerous situation at this moment. I couldn't possibly afford to send crew members out when we ourselves are in a precarious position with pirates out there and all that. Well, let's revive her and see what the situation is. Bring her to my cabin.
Yes, sir.
Can I come?
I suppose so, since you already know her. The captain's cabin is...
I'm still Major Armored Cabin.
That's... Well, now that you popped it, it won't go away for like 8 hours.
Yeah.
So the only way to get rid of it is to like put on armor. Okay, so you tag along, given that your quarters is actually only right across from Captain Rockface's.
Okay.
So it's... You find yourself that you can be curious enough that you can sit in your room while also listening to a conversation if you wish to.
I tell the captain if you need help, I can be of assistance. I'm just a tourist, but...
Nobody's tourists now that the ship has been crashed. Fine. Help the first mate and bring her up to my quarters. Let's get her revived.
Two Earth Genasi on the same ship. I'm curious.
What do you look like?
Oh,
okay.
I did
the photo.
Oh, damn. Oh, yeah, I did. So, something like that.
Printed up her own image and everything.
Oh, okay. What are you made of?
Made of? I'd say something like...
Gemstone?
Udial.
Oh,
okay. Press
the original picture is he's reddish brown.
Oh, good.
So, right. Not shiny, because Jujudo is shiny.
In that case, he just speaks to you in Primordial.
Oh, okay.
He says, very well, just bring her up to my room.
Okay. So, I
chosen
offer
languages.
To...
In that case, it makes a little more sense why your room would be across. From, because you... are comfortable in the same conditions.
Which is where?
Probably too hot for normal people.
Ah, okay.
The room has an earthy feel.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
That's gross. That's gross. Babe.
I don't get it.
You're not supposed to.
Nobody will. It will go with us to our graves. Anyway, so yeah, well,
sorry.
So you go to your earthy feeling rooms, and then. You lay Dr. Gertrude across a bed which has been padded first.
So I'm helping
food,
him?
Yeah. Food gets brought up and served.
I press the digitation the food to make it taste better.
Okay. Do you know for a fact that it doesn't taste good? Doesn't it taste so good?
Yeah, I've had this ship's food before.
Lad, do you think you can teach me to do that thing sometime soon?
Oh, absolutely. I have my manual right here.
I actually don't know when Eldritch Knights learn a new cantrip, but I think it's going to be a long time from now. But sure.
Okay, so...
You're enjoying calling everyone mad.
After she gets water and a little bit of a bite of food into her, you can see the colors begins to return to her face. Her eyes start to focus once more, and she and her breathing seems to be normalized now. She says, thank you. he turns to you and says, Dr. Ashford?
Yes, yes. I am Dr. Professor Ashford nowadays, actually.
Dr. Professor.
It's been a while. How have you been? How did you even get here in the first place?
It was the most amazing thing. A sailor reported, a sky sailor reported seeing an island in the middle of the sky. I knew that I had to pursue it at once. I now wish that I had stayed to build up a proper expedition with our university. But I felt that it was my only chance, so I grabbed whoever I could and they set sail.
So you just happened upon it by chance?
It was a rumor of a rumor that I chased. It was completely amazing. Based upon your findings and the studies of Dr. Eigerbach.
Mostly mine.
Of course. Is she aware of your rockstar ego?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
I've been like that since my university days.
All right. All right. In that case, then. Yes, of course. Of course, mostly yours. By extrapolating between her findings, yours, and the reports of the sailors, I was able to pinpoint the precise location of the island. I didn't want to embarrass myself by going straight to the university, so I made a straight shot, straight through here. I only intended to land, bring back some proof of the island's existence, and then return to the university at once to set up a proper expedition. But and it should have been to look around the skyship, and she says, but apparently you've already made a proper expedition of it.
Yes, it's actually sponsored by that old man, Eiderbach.
Everyone knows, right? Everyone believes that Eiderbach is right.
Well, yeah.
All right, only.
So even Dr. Drake would believe that. He says, Eiderbach, you mean, but surely you didn't. I find it completely amazing that you would work with Eiderbach on anything.
Yes.
Work.
This is an intriguing opportunity indeed. I mean, Arathea is right here. We are here.
Indeed, it would be absolutely amazing. But Professor, this deja vu, as I'm calling you Professor again.
Dr. Professor.
But Professor, the island is just not, it's not all ruins. There are things in the island, dangerous things. On our way in, we were accosted by these flying creatures.
Flying creatures?
Yes, these half-bird, half-men. Yes.
Half-bird. You're talking about Arakuk?
Arakuk? That might be it.
Sorry. I may not know that. Do I know that? Should I know that?
Sure, sure. I'll give it to you.
My wife would have looked to these Arakokra. What are Arakokra?
Exactly what she said. Half bird, half man.
Yes, but what do they do?
They fly.
Do they speak human language? I'm asking whoever's...
Go ahead and make a history check.
I have plus 4 to history, but 24.
He gives you a meaningful look. Perhaps it might be.
You got a 24.
24, okay. You happen to know that Arakokra are capable of speech. They are sentient.
They are intelligent. They do speak. And they fly. And they're birds.
You do know, that, however, that Arakokra are normally good. They're not marauding pirates as Dr. Virtue has mentioned. So it is a quite unusual behavior for Arakokra to attack an unarmed, unthreatening ship.
I pose a question to the good doctor, and so did they speak with you when they struck you, or were they just randomly so crabs?
We begged for mercy, but. It was so strange that they seemed to be apologizing to us as they abducted us off of the ship. When we eventually crashed into Arathea, thankfully. We held out for a few days with our supplies, but eventually we had to go into the forest to search for food and shelter. It was then that the rest of my crew was killed or abducted by these Arcocrans.
They are supposedly good. Maybe that explains the apologetic nature. But that just raises more questions than answers.
This is please, Professor.
Who are you with?
My comrades from the sailors from whom I heard. About that. Mm-hmm.
Sorry, what?
They're just bring down the thing. It just won't go down again. Alright. We can start again?
Yep.
Wait.
Sarah, yours is not recording yet.
Yep. I'm good.
This is the sailor himself who shared the rumor with me. Captain Briar Anmeth.
Captain
Briar Anmeth.
Anmev?
Anmev.
Anmev.
A-N-M-E-V. So, he says, I completely regret my impulsiveness. I wish that I had just waited, I had just filed for an expedition to the university, like, as per protocol, rather than rushing off for myself.
Yes, yes. Protocol, indeed. Luckily, I've been recently trained by the elves from the north, with some coaxing. But I do believe I can help, but I can't do this alone.
I look at the captain, like asking him, should we tell?
Should we tell?
Should we tell? Yeah.
Captain Rockface crosses his arms a little bit and says. Before you go crashing willy-nilly through unknown forests on a floating island, perhaps I should enlighten you a little bit. He says, this expedition to Arateo serves many purposes and to many individuals. Some of us are here for study. And others are here for darker purposes. First Mate Bast over here, I don't know if you've heard of them. He's a blood hunter.
Have we heard of blood hunters?
You can go ahead and make a history check. Or Dana, whichever you prefer.
I'll take history. I got a 20.
14.
Okay. You've heard of blood hunters, but it seems more myth than fact.
So they're blood hunters, so they're real.
You know of blood hunters, in fact.
I take out my notebook and I start sketching. Blood hunter, you say? you start
sketching a human dude.
He don't look cursed or anything.
You do know that the blood hunters take upon occult and sometimes taboo rituals upon themselves, taking on either the aspects of undeath or eldritch powers or lycanthropy upon themselves to enhance their abilities.
But with the magic.
But with the specific intent of hunting those same creatures.
You seem rather hairy.
We laugh. Bass just laughs and says, It's the witch hunters who look most human that you should be scared of.
First Mate Bast joined our expedition in order to hunt a very specific rare creature. There have been reports of flying rare creatures attacking many of the skyports.
Flying rare creatures.
So they must not be our cook. But that doesn't explain the apologizing.
Bast raises his hand and says, I think I can answer that. He says, I would have knowledge on this, right?
Sure.
So he says, when encountering lycanthropy, there are often two ways that one is subjected to. After infection, one either resists it subduing it until the point of until a certain point wherein the bestial nature only arises during the time of full moon or one embraces it.
I think it's midday.
No, right.
It's midday.
I think it's
full moon. When Bass mentioned full moon, he goes, also, we're
inside. Also, you're inside the
ship. Yeah,
we're inside. Oh, right.
Look, my whiz is 10, okay?
So,
my whiz is also 10.
Yeah, so he explains that...
That means you should have common sense. 10 is common.
Okay. You're not grog level.
Yeah.
Anyway, he's... And then the other form is that you embrace lycanthropy and in turn are subjected to the evil nature of the curse. There are different kinds of lycanthropes, but oftentimes when they resist it, their sanity is still held in their beast form.
The short of it is that there are dangerous creatures out there and more than just these birdmen. Know that if you intend to lead an expedition outwards. My recommendation, Dr. Durche, is that you stay here and your crewmates are lost. It would not be the first time for a crew of sky sailors to disappear away from port. Her tears begin to well up, and then she says, "Please, please. I wouldn't be able to sleep at night if I heard them screaming again.
Would
I
your
know
ship,
that they were taken alive."
Would your ship happen to have a sort of engine?
No, we would, but it is significantly smaller than this vessel.
Perhaps it could help, Captain. I mean, we do need parts.
The Captain Rockface mulls it over a little bit. Oh, while yeah. Rock is Virgie says, I happened upon the strangest ruins on my way over here, actually. I was tracking the... she takes it as... She holds the notes from you a little bit while Rockface is discussing with Bast. She takes the notes from you and she says, commit to me that you will save at least the crew members that are alive.
Of course, I will.
He says,
not sure about them, but I'll find others.
And then he writes. She draws a map to the last location of the ruins that she stumbled upon. She warns you that this is where she tracked the Arakokrins too. So to be wary of danger, as you were.
Oh, sorry. Anyway, the Rockface's conversation.
Yeah. Rockface ultimately wraps up his conversation with you, Bast, by saying it might be worth investigating, and I know that you're here for purposes other than this expedition. So go ahead. You can go ahead and pursue this if you wish. However, you cannot commit any crew that have not voluntarily.
I'm not crew. May I have leave to go with him?
You wish to hunt were creatures?
According to the map that I recently drew, it might be over here.
I studied the map. I peer over his shoulder and I
wink at the Dirty.
That's the most obvious.
I
the tongue up.
I have minus one charisma.
Did you just wink?
I look at the both of you and say,
I also have minus one charisma.
You wouldn't happen to have silver weapons on you, would you?
What do we know about lycanthropy?
Not much.
Not much. Silver weapon?
No.
I have a metal axe.
I have magic.
Bast pulls out two. Bast takes two rapiers and then pulls them outwards so that you can see the visible difference in the metal. One is steel and then one is silver.
What does
the
silver one look like?
I take out my non-silver paper.
I brandish my great axe.
All for one?
No.
Yes.
We're not doing that. I see. Sorry.
Bast says, lycanthropes are resistant to almost any form of physical damage.
Damn it! What about magic?
You don't know if magic can affect
him. Magic can affect him.
I do have ice magic, and
other than that, though, you're gonna need a silver weapon to get through their hide. And if these creatures are the things that I'm hunting, you're gonna need.
I coat my axe close to me, and I know my ice. Maybe can you just coat them in silver? I am not comfortable with fighting with anything else other than this
other than
thing.
Your...
This baby.
So adorable.
Other than your silver baby, you do have a silver dagger as well.
A dagger? What am I going to do with this flimsy little...
I look at her and smile and say, I look at him and smile and say, the thick hide of a lycanthrope. The thick hide of
is resistant, but immune. Immune to physical damage, though, it's not.
I suggest you keep that.
You might need
dagger. This. I have magic. Okay, I have minimal magic. Are you giving me the silver dagger?
I'll lend it to you. It's something that's handed to us in the order, so I might need it back. It also aids as a symbol of office.
Okay, so silver dagger. I thought I was going to be able to use my D12.
Motherfucker! I did not get the right cantrips.
Not on a weird
silver dagger.
Okay. Oh, sorry, what did you say?
I did not get the right controls for this machine.
Oh.
Wait, what?
No, I have sword burst at least. But, you know, I have to position myself properly.
And any weapon damage still does weapon damage.
Yeah. At least it's force for sword burst somehow.
Actually.
Okay.
With my claws.
Your claws don't count as magic until level 7.
No, but then I can enchant my claws, right?
You can, but only the d4 would do the damage. Because you do 2d4, right? One for claw and one for right.
Mm-hmm.
Only your right damage would affect.
Mm.
Okay. So, Rockface
says... I look grumpily at the small dagger.
Rockface says, well, if you're all committed to performing this act of extreme stupidity, then bring back something helpful.
So adventure, then!
Is that the dagger or the axe that you go to adventure then?
Axe. To
adventure. Maybe we can find a stick with that on.
The what?
Turn into a spear.
I look at Captain Rockface and go.
I wish you well. I will not be surprised if you do not return.
Or if I'm the, I grumble under my breath. Or if I'm the only one to return.
Okay. So you set up for your expedition. Dr. Dirty goes over the last few details that she can remember from the crash landing expedition, seeing the layout of the land from the sky. It should be only a few hours journey until you reach the ruins. And from then on, it will be quite dangerous.
I ask for something of the crew's, maybe something that the sailor gave her or something that she had on the ship so that I can track it by sight.
She gives you a broken compass which belonged to Captain Anel.
I take out a piece of cloth, she places it on my hand, and then I bring the cloth up to my face. I take a deep breath with it, and then I note the scent. And then I put the compass away.
Okay. Please, do everything you can to save them.
Yes.
Do it.
For your captain.
For the art, the captain. Captain. Totally captain. Always captain.
Totally captain.
You can go ahead and take packs. You can go ahead and take a potion each.
What?
A potion each.
Is it okay for you?
Is that available
to you?
Yes. It's either
Explorers or Dungeon.
May I borrow your book?
Oh. It should be...
Sorry, page... Is it one potion?
My wizard.
One health potion.
My wizard. What's up, my wizard?
Okay.
skills. So. Warlock. Ah, there we go.
I have...
Page 151.
Yeah.
I will take Explorer's back.
What options are you provided to you? Because
I only get Explorer's back.
One Explorer's back. So, it is a backpack.
Backpack.
Bedroll.
Bedroll. An escape. Tinderbox. Are you using this or not? Or you're not? You don't need it anymore.
I'm gonna copy the other.
Yeah, I'm dictating to you because he's already.
No, I'm gonna copy paste from the ones that from the one that I already have listed out.
Tinderbox. Ten torches. 10 rations. 10 rations.
Water skin. Dungeoneer is the one that gets pittance, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What are you getting?
Me? I got Dungeoneer stuff. It's okay. I just look at it. I'm good.
You were the one with the pittance. Not silver.
Uh-huh.
Is that a 1 or a 7?
That is
a 1. The 7 is beside it.
The devil is a lot.
Not too high, it actually bounces a lot.
Yeah.
Like, look at this.
Yeah, yours specifically.
Really light,
yeah.
Oh, where is it?
Okay. I got a 3.
I have a prayer book.
Well, first match to it. So,
this is standard D&D Pantheon, right? So I utter a prayer to the Lord.
Hello, okay. Huh,
a religious man.
Alright, so
a religious young man.
You make your way forward. You travel as close to the path of
But before we leave I kiss a picture of myself and they pocket it.
Okay.
seeing him kiss the picture, I look at him with a smile and say, "A wife at home?"
Oh
no.
Oh, a wife. Look, good for you.
Girlfriend?
Picture of me.
I recently lost my wife. I miss her very much. Good for you. Good for you.
Oh, sorry for your loss.
good for you.
It sounds so fast.
Your self-confidence is quite inspiring.
Goodness, that escalated quickly.
It sounds so fast.
So you're
okay.
Awkward forward.
I guess I just sulk for the rest of the I thought you had a wife.
What's
your
marking order?
I go first.
I am at the very back.
I go first, but I'm holding my axe.
Okay.
Go second.
I hold the dagger and the axe.
More creatures are immune, supposedly.
Oh, lad, take notes for me, will you? I'd like to review this adventure. After this is all over.
How old are you, by the way?
I'm 53.
Right. She enjoys calling everyone lad.
I'm 29.
Okay.
A rock star at 29.
I'm actually 40, but the curse keeps me looking slightly young.
Okay. You awkward forward into the forest. You awkward for about a good 2 hours.
Until someone breaks the awkward.
I got about 5 hours left on my armor then.
Okay.
Are you 5 hours?
5 hours left on the mage armor.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You reach the end of the tree line, and then the trees begin to thin out, approaching what appears to be ruins. You see fallen structures made of stone. You see monuments erected in long faded metal. You see dirty. You see overgrown vines everywhere. But most interestingly is that the ruins appear to have been sunken. In that a tower which would normally which would normally stand about 80 feet, you know, from the ground up, is only about 40 feet from the ground up, and then the rest of it appears to have been sunk into the ground. You can see a few figures flying above head. They are flying far enough above that they appear as normal birds. But go ahead and make an investigation check, everyone.
I'm actually proficient in all the int abilities.
Does Hunter's Bane come to
crack?
What are you proficient?
Oh, dang.
I got 11.
Faith in Undead.
Five.
Let me just read it out to you.
8 plus 5.
13.
I got a 13 on my
investigation.
I got an 11. Because if it involves Faith in Undead, I have an advantage on...
What's the name of that feature?
Hunter's Bane.
You have wisdom survival checks on Faith in Undead. Intelligence checks.
Undercalling.
It's not a survival check. It's not an intelligence. It's not an intelligence check to recall information.
This is Mercer stuff we're using.
Yeah. It is. Yeah.
All hail.
Well, we're gonna test your hands out today.
Not 20.
Wow.
That's true, but it's not.
No, I mean like I rolled a 20.
Oh, on the investigation.
Yeah.
What is your actual score?
20 plus...
I suspect you dumped me.
Yeah, I dumped it. 20! Just 20! the only part of int that I'm proficient with is religion.
Okay, so... you take a look up. Bast, you're able to extrapolate that from this distance, though they look like normal birds at this distance, they must be pretty damn big if they appear this size from this far away. You can see above you that they are just sort of circling the entirety of the ruins, and then their flight patterns begin to shift a little bit, and then one circles back to the tower, and then you can see that others begin to come out of the tower. About perhaps five of them now begin to fly and set into a sort of formation as they rapidly approach your location.
What are those? First me, do you recognize those?
Pasta, Zimba. I say with... Bast says drawing his sword.
Fighting now!
Bast says, maybe, maybe not. Maybe they might be friendly. Or maybe they might kidnap us. Depends. We'll check.
Alright.
Okay, so...
do they respect rock stars in the...
No.
Damn it.
If they've been living here all their lives, they don't know who you are.
Okay.
I guess my picture again. They
take his little...
It's like his just passing back.
You see that Arakokrans, about these 5 foot tall, half bird, half men, in format of them. Well, you know what Arakokrans are. Angel, like an angel in that two primary limbs, walking limbs, and then wings as well. With bird heads. It seems that a hawk, a falcon, a raven, a sparrow, and an owl are all bearing down upon you.
Oh.
Lovely birds.
Go ahead.
They're not lovely, they're not lowly.
Go ahead and set us up. I forgot to put your figures as well.
I was planning on taking the Shori actor this time as well. Because seeing the type.
Sure.
And I'm sure his acting chops would allow for such things. Found him.
I thought you'd go for William's method.
So basically, he's playing himself.
Yeah.
The actor is playing himself.
Yeah.
With all that ego, yeah, basically.
It's like, finally. I'm recognized for my talent and an actual character.
A role I was born for.
Can you pick out Saber?
It's like Ryan Reynolds discovering Deadpool.
Can you pull
all this time it was just...
Oh, can someone give me an update?
Burly.
Are you looking for this one?
There,
yeah.
That's
safe. So, shift to form,
can I? Are there no big, burly, brown men? No.
That sounded vaguely racist.
Huh? that's what my character looks like. Okay, this is fair enough.
Maybe three more of these here.
something you should say out loud in polite company. I'm looking for a big burly brown man.
Where are those?
I can make them rocks.
I'll just put this here.
Yes. Alright.
You can place. Wait. Space away.
Oh, I'm gonna do this.
Alright, just careful when you. Yeah, there.
You can, you can put your. Place your. Your here. And go ahead and pick some random moves for me. The wings the better, but otherwise it's fine.
Beer
on a good day. Ah shit, but this one doesn't stand. Or does it? Mm. It does.
One more. Wing zombie should be. There you go.
There we go.
Right. Excellent. I didn't know I had that many wing characters. Right. You're more.
Oh, wait, no, wait.
Oh, there you go.
Another beer.
I remember I got several of these. So, go ahead and set yourself up in your marching order. Coming out from here.
Yeah, I'm going to break that.
Yeah, that's fine. So you start here and then move forward.
Here? Is it like, here?
In your order. Yeah.
Going which direction?
Up this way.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. These are. One, give me a bunch of ones. Two, three. Okay. So they are currently in flight.
How high?
Perhaps inbound. I'm going to say they are maybe 30 feet off the ground.
30 feet off?
It's a bonus action to start blazing. Got it.
Okay.
30 feet up?
Yep. Okay, we go now first to Lysander.
Oh. What can I do? 30 feet down.
Take a defensive position.
Lysander, go ahead and make a. Perception check.
Perception?
With his feet.
Damn
it.
9 plus 2, 11.
11.
Alright.
Okay. I will.
Wait, are they hostile?
You do see that they are bearing weapons down upon you.
Oh, what do you mean bearing weapons down upon
the, they, so, they brandished and stuff.
Ah,
yeah.
Okay. Birdies.
Is it too late to be friends?
You could certainly try.
With my minus one purpose.
Can I... I don't think any of your charisma characters.
None of us.
Can I ask in Sylvan?
I will hold...
When you get to your turn.
I ready an action to wait. Is anyone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3,
so
4,
after you
5,
count
6.
5, you now count upwards 30.
That's our distance.
Do I see what weapons they're holding?
Yeah. Many of them are holding a bunch of javelins.
Damn it, they're just gonna throw stuff at us. I will. Crap.
We'll do that here.
I will ready an action. If one of them lands, I will run up to it and attack it.
That's both a movement and an attack.
You can only ready an action.
Okay. That's right.
You already can move first and then ready.
Oh, before you begin moving, I call on. If they are what we worry about, you might not want to get paid.
Damn it.
The curse is transferable.
The fuck? I don't have anything. I know, I will...
Throw the gun.
Does any one of them in particular look the biggest and the meanest, or?
Sure. The Hawk and the Falcon are particularly large.
Which one?
I would say the both yellows.
Both yellows.
They are particularly fierce looking.
Okay. I say they're too far. I try to hit one from here, and I will cast magic missile.
Okay. You just rolled 4d6.
4d4.
4d4.
What class are you?
Eldritch Knight. Eldritch Knight. Where is that?
Eldritch Knight, large battle axe.
Mm-hmm.
How's your back? If you need a chair, we can pull that out since
the range is 120 feet.
Tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Only 3d4s.
Mm-hmm.
And it's 1d4 plus 1 to each, so this is plus 3.
Your int is plus 1?
No, it says 1d4
plus
1. Yeah, it's just plus 1. I'm holding the dagger. I sheathe the dagger first, and I hold my arcane focus. My dead wife's ring.
Okay.
Which I wear around my neck.
Okay.
And I hold out my hand, and I shoot at this one, because it doesn't have.
Right. Well, it doesn't matter. Magic missile hits no matter what.
Alright, okay. This is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes.
Okay. 9, what type of damage is this?
Force.
Okay. You raise your hand out. What do your magic missiles appear as?
They are just tiny balls. They're blue, but they look like Rekka's fireballs. They shoot out one at a time.
Okay. It smacks the falcon. You get that one, right?
Yes, this one.
It smacks the falcon full on, almost puncturing one of its wings. It spirals downwards, perhaps a good 10 feet before it's able to catch itself again. It immediately appears quite beaten up by your magic missile. It doesn't.
I don't know why I have one spell not left.
We now
casting
go to.
Oh, you are the casting machine.
The Hawk.
Yeah.
Which will. See your move. It'll come down 5.
Oops.
10. And then dive bomb you.
Ouch. What's it?
It's on the ground.
Yes.
Throw it.
It will dive bomb you and make an attack with its talons. Rolls Vic's dice first roll of the game is a 15 to hit.
17.
So it comes down with its hand still grasping the javelin, but it attacks with its feet as it flutters just above you.
Mm-hmm.
It's clawing at you.
I parry with my axe.
You wave your axe, keeping him away from you. He's there, he's considered on the ground, however he is just floating.
Hovering?
Yeah, he is hovering just above the ground, attacking with his feet.
Okay, but he's...
You can consider him on the same, on base contact with you. Okay, we now go to Bast.
Hello, Birdie.
It's a free action. I call out in Common and Sylvan.
Common and Sylvan.
Common and Sylvan.
Okay.
I call out in both languages and ask. And say... if you need aid, we can offer it. But we will fight if we have to.
the hawk that is attacking Lysander says, please.
Oops.
sister, please, anything, any help would be of great assistance. However, we cannot halt in our attacks.
I say we'll fight this out, but we'll do our best to make sure that we can offer what aid we can.
With that, I call out the rest of the party. From as close as you are, Lysander, to the hawk, you can see that there is a strange collar around his neck. It's quite thick, maybe about this thick, and it appears to have rungs of metal on them.
He's wearing a collar. So I announce it to the party.
As a free action, I say, when you attack them, do it with the aim of disabling them rather than killing them. They're not here of their own will.
So any non-lethal attack, when you drop somebody to zero with an attack from within 5 feet of the opponent, you can choose to make it non-lethal.
Okay.
I shift as a bonus action.
Okay.
And then I strike out with
Go over real quick the benefits of your transformation.
I'm now up to 17 AC.
You now have advantage on your strength checks and your strength saving throws. You have a bonus to melee damage equal to half your proficiency bonus, so it's one. You have your AC goes up by +1. And your unarmed strikes are considered a weapon, D4.
Mm-hmm.
You are also now vulnerable to silver.
Oh, yep. Damn.
And you now suffer bloodlust. So
I have to
roll wisdom saving throws at every attack. Every time you take damage.
Sounds like Mercer's thing.
Yes.
Very balanced. Rather balanced.
Okay, so
I'm like a mini barbarian.
Go ahead, make your attack.
I strike at him with my mighty striker. Since I used up my bonus action for the transformation, I cannot use my offhand attack. My offhand being the silver weapon, my main hand being steel right now.
Okay, sure.
So basically this is me testing whether or not if this hurts them really bad, they're not affected. If it doesn't, that means that they are afflicted.
Mm-hmm.
I make the attack. Plus,
should be about 5.
My dex is +3, so I'm up to
5 more.
Yeah, so it's +5. So, sixteen
will hit. How are you proposing to attack to make it non-lethal?
Our rapier being the way it is, with one side sharp, instead of striking with the blade, I strike with the back or the flat of the blade.
Okay, alright. So you're thinking of thicker rapiers.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Almost cutlass-like.
Sure. Go ahead and roll your damage then.
It's 88. This is... So this is 1d8.
There's one
plus
enemy
three,
plus one. Next, and then it's you. Zeros.
8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I do 12 damage.
Okay.
Wow. One weapon, too.
Alright, so
I only have 9 turns remaining on my ship.
You come up beside Lysander. You just give a few quick jabs, but really, you with the intent of just smacking the side of the falcon's head. Punk! You whip him over the side of the head and he goes down. He crumples to the floor unconscious.
I call out to as I end my turn, I call out to the rest of the Arakokrans and say, come strike at us. We'll try to help you as best we can.
Just them, not me.
And then
what's going on?
Okay, this.
Magic.
Magic. Imagination.
Which is essentially D&D. That's what you play with.
Okay. He makes a...
Oh, it's a one shot. Oops, yeah. Sorry.
He's gonna fly forward.
Oh my god.
Take a dive bomb. The professor.
Professor! Doctor Professor.
Go ahead and take the flying.
Doctor Professor.
I just said them, not me! Damn it!
The Falcon says, I'm sorry, I can't control it.
And then makes an attack against you.
Not the face! Not the face!
Oh, he's also beating up. I mean
18 to hit.
Oh, that hits.
Will you react now?
I
call out. I call out to the professor.
I'll take it.
You take it. I call out to the professor and say,
"Oh my god!"
A manly scar would add to your rock star image.
As he did make a dive attack.
Oh, my wife did love my battle scars. Ladies love battle scars.
7 slashing.
And that's it. Oh, that's it.
Okay.
Combined, as he comes down at you full force, even the momentum knocks you a little bit off your feet. You get knocked back a couple of feet as you try to fend him off. His claws are raking at your
Professor Lad.
You take additional damage to your arms only as you really do everything you can just to protect the face.
Manly scars, Professor! Manly scars!
Battle scars!
Now they're really weird scars that are underneath your armpits coming up.
Yeah, sure, that's quite. Attractive.
This would look good in the magazines.
Especially when you do that pose. Yeah, when you do the pose.
You post nude?
I was with Brary once.
Mr. Febrary.
Professor Ashford. What do you do?
I took out my rapier, and as a bonus action, I start flourishing and spinning, and I'm going to show you what the elves taught me. Blade singing.
Let's see.
You actually sing
one. You actually sing so many times.
Nice.
Something
popular. Yeah. Basically, well, nothing much on attack. So
okay.
I'm just gonna roll for an attack on this guy.
All right.
With my rapier.
Are you proposing to make it non-lethal? Is that
yeah.
Right?
Okay. But that's only a 10.
Plus.
That, no, it was a 5.
Oh,
it was
5. 10. Okay, that's... Can I, almost strikes him.
Can I see the...
But, as you launch out, you get into your rhythm of blade singing, you strike out, and then he goes for the face. Causing you to react poorly. And,
Gentlemen, to me! Because I'm blade singing.
Oh, because your voice is going to drop.
Oh,
so your balls drop as you blade singing.
The balls drop. Not the bass, the bass.
Okay, so...
Okay, well, how did you... Oh, sounds very mad. Huh, they grew up pretty fast.
This particular...
The elves hated my voice.
This particular raven dive bombs... dive bombs the best. Making an attack against him. Only a 7 to hit. So he, as he comes by, you block, you dodge, you...
I duck.
Okay, you duck. He flies right over you. Yeah, he comes back around and you put yourself in a defensive posture.
I quickly recall what they taught us in the Brotherhood, which was duck, dive, dip, duck and dodge.
A second one
dive bombs you.
Pretty equal rolls on your dive. 19 to hit.
A hit.
Okay, he is going to deal.
Alright, I see it now.
6 slashing damage.
That takes me down to 19. And I now make a whiz throw.
Yes.
Oh no!
I believe that as long as you're above 50% health, your DC is only 10. Okay?
Are you... What's your health?
I'm at 19. Only when I go down to 12, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do I have to make
higher
level?
Oof. Yeah.
As he strikes you, a feral rage ignites within you. How would it manifest in your hand?
You notice that my pupils, while I'm currently transformed, are circular, and at the same time, I'm speaking. If bloodlust were to trigger, the pupils would slit.
Oh, okay.
And then instead of speaking, a low growl would always emit. So, as a wear saber tooth, do not get away.
As each talon sinks into his flesh, you can, being right beside him, you see that his pupils waver between the circular humanoid and the cat-like. The cat-like slits of the wear. What wear creature are you, by the way? You never showed them your leg.
Oh, yeah, I'm a wear saber tooth.
Oh,
it's a rare variant of the word cat. Of the word tiger girl.
Kitty cat. Oh.
So you can see in typical beast like beast from X-Men that he's what color are your eyes?
Brown. Hazel, okay. Or rather hazelnut. Okay.
They're brown and they turn sort of yellow as
he
crashes.
What's going on?
He becomes unable to answer you just for a second before he clears his throat.
Sorry, that was dangerous.
The owl
flies
over the battlefield and dive bombs you from behind.
Hey, crap.
Making an attack against you.
Oh, whew.
Okay. The natural 20.
Oh!
Oh!
Is that my dice?
Yes.
Gee, thanks.
Thanks?
Thanks?
I should have given you this one.
Head twist inside with you. Thanks.
Fortunately, you only take 10 damage.
10?
Considering how much you could have done.
I'm 21.
Alright. Hey, you're almost as low as his maximum health.
Yay!
They know that you can second wind.
Yeah.
So, and I would recommend that you second wind during combats as you become incapable of second winding outside of combats.
Really?
Otherwise, you could just,
you just use
second wind all the time until you reach max. So you can only second wind in combats.
Alright, so. I only have 1 second wind.
Yeah,
that
but it's
for
short
rest.
Right?
I should put that short rest.
Okay.
Can you turn
the owl
1 degree? Like, make it 2?
Oh, there you go.
It's starting to shake.
So, the owl flies over the battlefield, trying to pick and choose its best target. Seeing you preoccupied with the two in front of you, it swoops in silently and claws at you.
Oh, ow!
You feel it scratch. You hear the squeal of claws, of talons on metal. And a few shavings of brass break forth as it slashes.
Oh, battle scars!
We come back up to Lysander.
Oh, me.
I laugh and say, I'll handle these. You take the one behind me.
Turn and how do I make it?
Take the one with me.
I'm quite preoccupied right now, young man.
How does it feel being the oldest one in the party?
How do I make it non-lethal with?
How are you striking the flat of your axe?
Yeah,
I guess.
Or the
pole.
Or the pole. I can use the pole.
The haft.
Haft. I don't know what it's called.
Tear my new axe.
So I'll describe with 8.
It's 5.
Would you like to action search?
You can. It's a 13.
Huh?
Wait, 10? Oh, wait.
No, my
let's roll the 3.
Eight. Oh, okay.
5 plus 3, 8. 3 plus 5 is 8. Wow.
Or would you like to second win? Those are both
options.
Sure,
how often do you recover them?
Short rest.
We can take a short rest after this. We'll have to interrogate them anyway.
I guess I'd action search. Hopefully it is.
Let's see.
21.
21, that'll definitely work.
Is it still a D12?
Yeah.
I've never used a D12 before.
Whee! 1.
Oh!
Die! 12! 15, but it's bludgeoning. Is it bludgeoning?
I'll consider it still mechanically, it doesn't change the type of your dice.
Oh.
Okay, so...
I'm sorry, Mr. Owl.
Okay. You, as the owl claws across the back of your neck, you turn around to it. You stand fully about... How tall are you?
About 6.
Okay, you stand a foot taller than me, so it comes up to your... Just above your chest.
Sorry,
tiny owl.
You briefly apologize. It's... Bang! And he just... Boom! He just falls unconscious.
Why is everyone so apologetic?
As you strike him across the face, the owl's head goes back almost 360 degrees. And then boom, falls on his back.
Luckily they can actually do that.
There was a comic about Metal Gear, where all of the people were animals, and then Metal Gear Solid Snake was also an animal. I think he might have been a fox. I'm not sure.
Not a snake.
But he went about, and then he saw the first guard. It was a tiger. He came up. He cracked the neck, and then he saw a second one. It was a pig. He went up. He cracked the neck. He saw it came up on a bird. And he went up and he cracked the neck, but then when he turned it around, it was an owl. So the owl just turned around and gunned him down.
Okay.
So I was trying to break.
I will second him. I use my bonus action to second him.
Sure, go.
What is it? Wait.
1d10 plus your.
3. Level 3.
Can I attack separate targets with both of my attacks?
7 health.
7
health.
Right.
21.
28. What's your max?
28.
I have a
28.
Okay.
Alright, we go now to
Bash. I attack separately. The silver rapier to the one on my right and the steel to the one on my left.
Alright.
So this is for the silver. It's a 19. That will hit. And then this is for the...
Were you hitting with the silver?
Him. That's his left hand, I keep forgetting. And then this is for the steel. Oh my god.
Ah.
I will knock it. Luckily that was the steel one, not the silver one. Otherwise that would have hurt.
No, it doesn't matter either way. You're doing non-lethal damage on either of them.
No, but since in this form I'm susceptible to...
Oh, that's correct. And we have special rules for you.
We agreed. Yeah, we agreed that if...
He's
using something that he's vulnerable to. When he rolls a 1 on his silver sword, he takes damage.
Oh my god.
Luckily that was the steel sword with that strike, so that one did not F me in the B. 2 plus 3, 5 plus 1, 6. 6 damage with...
On which one?
This one.
Bear.
Okay, that will be the...
Also, I make a mental note to... I also make a mental note.
How much damage did you do?
6.
6, okay. You come up and you whack him across the face with the flat of your blade. He shakes it off. He's a little bit woozy, but he continues his attack.
As a free action, I take those with the collars and make a mental note to bring back a sample of his order.
It could help.
Restraining
the falcon in front of you. Hovers just a little bit and gets another few attacks out. He rolls... unfortunately.
Me?
21. He rolls 21 to hit.
I cast Chain.
Alright. What form does your shield take? Not your face, I assume.
Look.
Because you wouldn't want them to strike at your face.
No. I draw a circle in front of me and it becomes a force field. A golden force field. So, like my eyes.
Alright, so the falcon strikes across his shield, and as he does, he says, "Did you ever notice that this matches the color of your eyes?"
Ah, that's on purpose. I like you.
We now go to you, Zeros.
I like your banter. Sorry, I like your banter.
I move over here. That doesn't trigger anything.
No.
Then I will make another
to roll out. Because it's too, it's too light.
No, no, that's can't.
Just to try again, just try again.
Oh, maybe rolling into it. Nah.
What is that? 16 plus 5. 21?
That'll definitely hit. You might want to put a metal ball bearing inside next time.
Like, but that'll affect balance.
Yeah, it won't be balanced.
Oh, so. That's true.
Plus 3, 6 damage.
Okay. How are you proposing to make it a non-lethal?
I hit him with the
pommel.
With the pommel of my sword. So okay. As I'm blade singing, I duck underneath and I hit him in the
rib. And it knocks the wind out of him and he curls up on the ground like groaning.
Excellent fighting skills.
You take him out of the fight.
Oh, I did? Mm. Oh, nice.
He was already damaged.
Oh, yeah, from the...
We now go to facing these two. I then speak out. Little help might be appreciated.
This one in, makes his attack against you.
Later.
That's only 8 to hit. But the Spyro beside it makes it its attack against you as well. 16 to hit. In your transformation, it doesn't hit.
Mm-hmm.
We now go back up to Lysander.
I
call out behind me. Friend, aid might be appreciated at this point.
Aid it is then. And we'll attack him. No, 3.
Oh, shit. 8.
8. Okay. You make a wild attack against the raven. The raven, it caws and it flaps away a little bit as the battle axe.
Stand still, we're going to help you.
Listen, I can't control it. And then we go down to the bast.
I make the separate attacks again.
Okay. One on separate.
One on either. Okay. That's a 20 on the first one.
Okay, that'll hit.
That's 14 on the second one.
14. That'll also hit.
Nice.
You roll your damages separately.
Yep. So, silver, steel.
Silver's going on the raven. On the
bear.
On the sparrow.
Mm-hmm. So silver, steel.
Okay.
The steel does 9. The steel does 12. So on this guy, that's 12. And then on this guy, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 damage. So the
you have a fighting stat?
Yeah, 2 weapon building. And because you get
blue building. Okay, so the sparrow you launch out with your steel blade. Pang! You hit him across the head, he goes down immediately. With the raven, you do how much? Damage 5?
Yes.
Okay. So you... what's the combination? You roll the 1 then?
Yeah. 1 plus 3 and then plus 1 from the ship. From Fertile Might.
Okay. This one, you catch in the gut with your palm and like... But he remains standing. And you go to Zeros.
Okay. I will...
Actually, it was reversed. The other one... It's the one that fell.
Oh.
That one.
Okay. Hi, it's easy for you to get this.
I will prance around over here.
Okay. Very, very fanciful.
And
you prance.
Okay.
You prance 3, you prance 15 feet.
I prance 15 feet while spinning my blades around.
Mm-hmm. Very good dancing. My wife and I
didn't like my singing voice.
Okay.
Mother freaking, that's a 4. Shit, it's a 9 only.
9 to hit, okay.
I'm gonna use luck.
Sure, go. Go ahead.
Oh, you got luck.
But no, I might use it for a witch bolt later.
Okay.
Alright.
yeah,
it. Okay. Seeing as that you are dancing about. Your natural AC is now
19,
so it's probably easier to hit. The Lycanthro, so he's gonna attack the Lycanthro.
If this succeeds,
then I fail on the throw. At least I'm not next to you.
He sees you. Which is kind of weird. And attacks the other guy's
head. Am I not good enough for you? Actually, go ahead.
He rolls a 22 to hit.
Your shield's over? Oh, okay.
It ends in your turn.
It ends in your turn. It's a reaction.
Yes, but I believe the AC lasts until the beginning, of your turn.
Yes, it's a one round thing.
So you could. Basically, if somebody hits you once, you can activate the shield, then it lasts as so everyone else hits you.
So if I'm like last in the initiative order,
it sucks.
So it's a good idea if the first guy who attacks me pops the
box. Yeah, exactly. He deals a 6 slashing damage to you last.
It
puts me at 13, just above. Oh! Same as Zeros. I don't suppose any of you are healers, huh?
No, we don't have a healer in this party.
Though they say my dancing is quite soothing.
It is quite soothing, actually.
Well, we go up to...
Wait, I have to make the saving throw.
No, you make it at the beginning of your next turn.
Oh, okay.
Like Sandy, go ahead and make your move.
Mm-hmm.
I think so.
Oh. I guess I'll squeeze myself in between.
Mm-hmm.
And.
Wreck him!
19.
Superly wrecked.
23.
Mm-hmm.
This was 3. That's 6.
6 damage.
Six.
Okay. You catch him with just the very end of the haft of your, battle axe. Of your great axe, it knocks him to the ground, but he flutters back up because he's holding his ribs. He says, "Please, make it quick."
Make it quick, lads.
We go to Bast. He makes his saving throw.
If this fails,
you are
at 30, just above half.
Still
DC 10.
Look it up.
13. Okay.
Okay.
I'll make the attack. One is a 21, the other one's a 15.
Both will hit.
One is a 12, the other one's a 9.
Okay. How do your attacks go?
This is to knock him out, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do our cover have ears?
No. Okay. They have indents where their ears would be.
So. I punch him in the gut with the handguard of my rapier, and then that's with the silver one, and with the steel, I knock him over the head.
Okay. He collapses onto the ground,
groaning. I take out a rope, and then I say, we should probably tie them up, so that they can't do anything, and then figure out what those collars are.
Wait, let me finish.
I don't let him finish.
It's gonna take a few seconds.
I begin pulling the arco to the corner.
Alright.
I tie them together. I tie their wings together so that we can preserve rope because they can't fly together.
Okay.
And then
so you tie their wings and their hands separately.
I want to tie their wings.
I have silk rope if you would like.
I want to tie their wings.
They've got twice as much rope as I need.
Okay. So let's just tie one.
I'll let you spend 5 feet of rope for every arco turn.
Okay.
And if you're separating their wings and their hands, then it will be 10 feet for every article.
Yeah.
There are 5 articles.
So 10
so
feet.
So 50 feet.
50 feet? Okay. From you? Me?
Yeah.
So we use up all 50 feet?
For now, yeah. For now.
Okay.
We'll retrieve it when we figure it out. And I look at the smart one and go.
Go ahead and roll the initiative for the next fight.
That is
a 1.
No, that's 11. 11 plus
14.
18.
20.
20.
Okay.
20. Wow. Lucky on initiative. It's just 20.
I look at the smart one and go, Professor, care to prove your intelligence?
One second. 5 seconds.
I tried to imitate.
Two, one.
Oh, fuck.
You sense that perhaps he took some of the forms a little too literally when they were taught to him. As such, he has to time them precisely to the duration that was taught to him.
Huh, but I thought you could end that. Can't you end that thing when you want to?
Then it would be finished. Who'd want that? A performance unfinished in the middle. Monsters.
He's the cock. He's like the marriage of Dingleton, Mindhoff, and Liberius.
His name is Azeros Ashford Dingleton.
Are you happy?
I would like to inspect one of the colors. Maybe an arcane check for that one.
Sure, go ahead.
Shit. This is 6 plus 5, 11 only.
11. You can tell it's certainly foreign to them, given their rather primitive armors and weapons. It is certainly more technologically advanced and magically powered.
I try to bump the head of one of them.
Hey, wake up, you!
He sort of shakes awake. Which one do you like?
The one who likes me. The one who likes the father.
He doesn't like you, he just noticed
the same color. He just noticed the same color.
Might tell me why you got this collar. It was very interesting, intriguing, technologically advanced.
He's tied, right? So he's tied up. He looks around. He says, are they all still alive?
Yeah. Yes.
No, don't worry about that. You didn't check my face. Nobody dies.
He says, the Skaven.
The Skaven?
Do I recognize
this? What?
You can go ahead and make history checks, but it's a fairly high DC.
Is it related to my prey?
Can I?
Sure, you can
try.
Consider it related to
me. Can I try?
Can I also try?
Make
yes?
It an advantage.
No? Okay.
Yeah. Go. All of you can try, and yes, it is related.
Motherfucker! You got a 1.
Not nice today.
You are not a very good
player.
16.
19? I'm sorry.
You got a 19?
Yes.
Okay. Given your wife's penchant for arcane and obscure history, you've only vaguely heard of the Skaven. Skaven. S-K-A-V-E-N.
Okay, Skaven. Vaguely heard. Yes. What have I
heard? The Skaven supposedly were cursed humanoids from a very, very long time ago. You know that
it's a place?
They are people, a race.
Oh, right.
They are vicious rat humanoids.
Oh, that shit.
Rat humanoids.
Yes. Who supposedly spawned from a particularly evil deity smiting a race that he felt had betrayed him. And so they were cursed to become the Skaven. These vile, vicious creatures who enjoy infesting, corrupting, and conquering various lands. But they are sort of a boogeyman in fairy
so
tales.
Like
from, yeah,
like
fairly mythological. The falcon says,
Skaven.
Yes,
Skaven. Real? Like, are
what
they
happens
the,
if we remove
their humanoid?
If you can, please do. The Skaven, they were. We had not known of them until we had flown to this island. We sought to make a nest here. However, we were quickly captured and enslaved by these Skaven. They've put these collars around us. And now, if we do not enforce their will, which my fellow guards and I were tasked with attacking intruders. If we do not enforce their will, he sort of bends over to let you see into the inner workings of the collar. It's about this thick, and it goes all around like that.
Oh.
And you can see that it now houses several spikes that point inwards.
Oh.
Before that, what's your wife's name? Very knowledgeable in stuff I don't know, which I'm supposed to get.
Helena.
What's your last name?
Tristan.
Tell them Tristan.
Can I,
you can make history check. Where did your wife die? How did your wife die?
Civil unrest in
13?
My city, so she was one of the civilian casualties.
You've heard of the name as attributed to specific findings, but it's from a foreign city, so you never really gave it much thought. But now that you actually give it some thought, she is noteworthy.
Interesting.
Perhaps you find my wife before.
No, but I've read her readings a few every now and then.
Oh yeah, she loves
interesting stuff.
She has done some research with her.
Where can I find
her? I myself am not quite interested, but she talks about it all the time.
Where can I find a woman like that who's also as pretty as I am?
I take this moment to look back at the Emperor Pigleton here. Say, I want it nearly possible, by the way.
Okay.
So, I would like to make an investigation check to just ascertain whether it would kill them to attempt.
Has anyone?
Go ahead and make. Do you have any sort of tinkering tools proficiency now?
No.
Just
I only have
navigator.
Okay,
check then.
But navigator tools. No. Okay.
Leave this to the smart people.
Investigation or arcana, whichever you prefer.
Use tools. Investigation. Yes, natural 20 on investigation.
Okay.
25.
Nice.
Okay. You see that if you were to go about it, if you were to botch it, it might go off.
A risky proposition. If we make a mistake, you might die.
The Falcon looks down a little bit and he says, "If it were only I that I had to look out for, I would consider it. I would rather freedom of the skies than this slavery." Unfortunately, the Skaven do hold our eggs within their warren. So
yes.
I am unable to. I am afraid that I cannot give up this life just yet.
I look at the
save the children.
We can either attempt to. We can either figure out a way to take out the colors and attempt it, or we can leave them tied up first with some rations, of course. Will we try to figure out a way to do that?
I'll consider this all a short rest. So you can.
Oh yeah.
You can also spend hit dice as you want.
I want to use my arcane recovery.
Sure, go ahead. You recover one first level spell slot?
Does that have a combined level that is equal to or less than half? Yes, so I'm going to recover one level one spell slot.
Alright.
I recover 8 health, so I go up to 21.
21.
I think I have 4 hours left after the short rest for my wage armor.
And I am down to
31. Can I use... sure, I'll use my hit die.
Right.
Oh, yes, me too.
Alright,
I'm not a tank.
Also, I'm back to full, because I'm only at 20 and my con is 3.
Okay,
so
five.
I'm back to 41.
I get my shift back.
Got it.
I'm at 18 health.
I don't get my spell slot back, because I'm not a casting machine.
Did you take a short rest? Or did you hit dice?
Yeah.
How much did you regain? 8. I went up from
15 to 21. I'm at full health again.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. So much yeah.
Well,
I look to the other cooker who is awake and I ask him if it looked like the Skaven had a way to remove the colors.
Indeed, they held these arcane keys that were capable of locking and unlocking our colors at will.
Would one key be able to unlock all colors?
That I do not know, but
can I see a keyhole though?
Just looking around it, you don't see a keyhole. You suspect that the mode of unlocking mechanism may be magical in nature.
For this,
that you can try to pick the lock, as it were, using arcane methods if you wish.
That being as it is, best just still party. Maybe we should go inside, find
inside the ruins. Yes.
Yes. Fine. Listen first.
Greed.
Listen first. I suggest we go inside for a lone Skaven.
Do we know how dangerous these skavens are? How dangerous are? Would
you're the one with the popular wife.
You're the one that. Well, you,
but how much do I know from.
Well, you know that they are vicious conquerors.
Ah, okay. What, they're rat humanoids, right?
Whether they be lycanthropic in nature or human, they as a rat species, I'd have to assume that their tactic would be to swarm and overwhelm. If we can find and secure a single one, or even encounter a party that encounter a lot of them that we'd be able to handle, grab the key. Free the Arakokra, it would make it so that we could, with their aid, attempt to regain the eggs and look for whatever you were looking for inside the ruins.
Yes, yes. He says, I mean, save everyone, of course.
No.
Save the eggs.
Remember, to be a hero, you have to help people first.
No. Historians don't become heroes. It's nothing to us.
Also, less danger to your face.
That's the most important bit, really.
That's the most important thing.
Okay. Uh-huh. How are you?
We will proceed into the ruins.
Yes. We're gonna look for one of the Skaven guards. That's a bastard suggestion.
Might we proceed?
Yes.
I pat my chainmail. I'm afraid that will be an issue.
Why don't you go rush it first, attract all the Skavens, kill them all, and come back here?
Yes. Let's do that.
I suggest.
Well, anyway, if we cannot try to be quiet.
The Falcon says,
"Well, if you intend to invade Warrenthar."
Warrenthar.
Yes, the city Warren of the Skaven. If you intend to infiltrate Warrenthar, then you might want to take. Perhaps one of the tunnels, rather than a direct approach. They are quite numerous.
Well,
he gives you a brief layout.
I try to map it out, but you're the navigator.
Can I swing go ahead and make a survival check? Can I spend 2 days ration feeding all of them?
Survival.
Like I put food in front of them, so when they wake up.
I got a 10.
You got a 13.
I got a 10.
Okay.
I don't have
an assist, and then you can roll an advantage.
Advantage.
I leave food for the Arakokans so that when they wake up, they don't get
starved.
Okay.
10.
Go ahead and deduct that from here.
It's just a 10 or a 6. 10.
10. Okay. Alright, so.
You do your best to map out the location, but given that you're unfamiliar and that it's land-based navigation, and that the layout of this land is completely unfamiliar to you, you have a rough approximation of where the thunder might be.
So the Skaven are a Tian, you say?
A what?
I don't know if they are native to this land. I know only that they were here before us.
If you can provide me with something of their scent, I might be able to track.
Why's everyone? How come everyone has been here before I have, or even Eiderbach? It makes no sense.
I look at the befuddled.
It's just like how America was discovered by
the Vikings were first.
So many. Discovered by the Europeans, of course.
Sure,
by Britain.
Sure. Of course, totally.
England totally discovered America.
Why would it be strange for them to arrive first?
Because I'm a historian. We're all supposed to be first. Damn it!
I look at the historian and say, "Why is my?"
The Falcon says that. He looks down at his collar and says, "In all honesty, I wish you were."
You realize.
As do I. Then I'd have beaten that idol back to the punch.
I wave.
I put the food in front of the Falcon. So I asked him for like.
First mate, maybe the collar has some sense. Do they handle the collars themselves? Do they hold it? Maybe there's some. If you're looking for. Something to smell.
Yeah.
You could make a survival check scent if you would like. If you would like to specifically note the scent of a Skaven.
Is that. Do I'm, I, I'm not gonna say the words that always jinx me when I do it, but like,
you mean you're proficient in it?
Shut up! And then I, with Keen Smell, do I make it an advantage, right?
Yeah, go ahead.
As you do that, it's gonna read the messages again.
Oh god, senpai, yeah.
I am at the 19.
If only those texts added to your rolls.
Unfortunately, they don't give D10 version in game.
Okay. You know the particular scent of Skaven. It does smell a lot like rats. When you're sniffing it, you smell the rats. You smell the Skaven, which are different, but you also scent something else. You scent the very sharp and familiar particular scent of perhaps a were-rat as well. Ah, shit.
Yes.
You smell shit.
No.
Well, yes, you also smell shit.
Oh, yeah. Yes, that too.
Prestidigitation.
Oh god, the scent's gone.
Oh no, how are we supposed to track that?
Like, that's this. It's not just Skaven in there, they've got a were-rat too. They could be infecting people having them.
Ah, shit.
Go ahead and make an investigation check and an advantage.
Oh, motherfucking shit. Oh, I forgot I'm a sailor. I haven't cursed yet.
That is a 15. Okay, no care. You suspect, with the presence of Arakokran and the reports of flying lycanthropes and the set of a were-rat, you might have an Arakokran were-rat.
Shit.
Flying
were rats. Arakokran were rat.
That sounds like an adventure.
I look at the rest of the party. I'm a cat! They're not supposed to fly!
Cats eat rats, do not.
And also birds.
And birds.
Oh!
That's like double meal for you.
Saber-tooths can't fly! Did you bounce?
Yeah.
Not that high! I look at the falcon and say, not that high!
Okay. I wonder if Arakokran wings can be transplanted into.
It might not be the best idea at the
fuck you guys to like squiggle away.
Help. Oh, right. Death over skies, yes. Maybe next time.
Okay, so, how will you choose to proceed? As far as you can see this moment, you can see that if you take the path downwards into the basin that that the entire city sinks into, you will come across several entrances into the complex within. It has several walls as well you could attempt to scale, or you can attempt the hidden hind entrance that you tried to map out earlier.
I say we go to the hidden entrance as long as it doesn't smell bad.
It will.
I say we go to the other thing.
I look at the falcon first and I ask him if him and the rest of the guards have been bitten and or scratched or have come into contact with either a Skaven or a special.
Of course, come into contact with the Skaven.
I mean, have they caused damage to you?
Well, of course, they beat us bloody every day.
Okay.
Have you encountered one of the Skaven that had wings?
Unfortunately, there are a few of us that are taken away and they return different.
None of your party are among them, right?
No.
Okay. Those might be the infected Arakokrans.
It's bad.
Flying were rats that are immune to anything but silver, very bad.
That is a bad thing. Except magic.
Okay. But still very bad.
How do you choose to proceed?
Preferably without encountering any resistance.
That might be
the worst thing. So resistance first, rather than...
So one or the other, actually.
I offer you a trade.
Trade?
I'll take the silver dagger, you can borrow my rapier.
Sure, okay. Not that.
Because I can enchant the silver dagger
you can, it's
with
you can use strength.
I can offer the.
Because I can enchant the silver dagger rapier, with the blood right.
Even with your dagger.
So it goes up to a D8 anyway.
Well, no.
No, it goes up to collective to D4 as well. I lend you.
Okay.
I hand you my silver rapier and say, please be careful with it. I was the one that. I had a large hand in crafting that.
I wave it around. Sarah,
Sarah's does this.
I return you my. I return your dagger.
I look at you and say, are you going to be fighting in melee with rats?
You've seen me fight.
But
magnificently.
Oh yes, the dancing is quite.
But close up.
I think my wife would like your dancing.
With rats in your face trying to chomp your nose off.
Well, not. No, I don't look good hairy. So.
Plus, we've got two meat shields in front of us.
Ah, yes. And be very good meat shields.
Unless we encounter the flying rats. So, Basil, actually, your health is now 21. So you are 4 points below your maximum. So if you activated your crimson right now, it will have no effect on you other than to reduce your maximum.
Wait,
health.
Is it a silver rapier or is it a normal rapier?
Silver.
Oh, it's a silver rapier. Nice.
So you could actually activate your crimson right now, and then all it will do is reduce your maximum health, which has no effect on your current health because you're now below.
I'm gonna activate the crimson right now, and I enchant the.
Oh, what is the crimson?
I'm going to enchant the. My steel rapier.
It's steel rapier, okay.
So that I can still attack with both.
Okay.
Enchant?
Yes. The blood right of the blood hunters allows me to imbibe my weapon with a singular effect from one of the given effects of the blood rites.
Which
I can choose either from flame, frost, or storm. I choose storm.
Let lightning guide me.
Most things die with fire, but that's up to you.
No, but flying, you know, isn't lightning super effective?
So your maximum health goes down to 22.
It takes from your HP.
Yeah, and I can't. It'll when the effect of the thing wears off, I can go back up to my maximum health. But until that point,
okay.
I am down to 22.
Your steel rapier must always be unsheathed and must always remain within your hand.
Yep, gripping it tight in my right hand.
Alright, so you proceed to
tunnels.
The hidden secret tunnel. Okay.
We shall go to the secret tunnel.
Are you attempting to be stealthy?
I can try. We can.
I don't suppose you have passive.
Okay, so
I
guess you're attempting to be stealthy.
Attempting to be stealthy.
17 plus 3. I got a 20.
19 plus 3.
I just saw a 3 on your other die.
Yeah, that's probably the.
That could still be a 1.
3.
Okay. Alright, you leave the Arakokrans, Bast, having left some food for them to peck away at.
And water, of course.
You don't leave people tied to a tree. Not to eat the food.
How will they eat?
Who is holding the map?
Yeah.
Go ahead and make a survival check.
Hold the map for me.
Go ahead and already make the survival check.
Wait, who's making the survival check?
Yeah.
Him.
It's gonna be a flat with check. 17.
30.
Alright. You
try to figure out what you had previously helped create, but no.
Oh! It was upside down all along, sorry. And then you manage to make it all the way what appears to be basically a hole in the ground. At first it appears to be just an overgrown sinkhole, looking further into it, you see stonework, indicating that perhaps it leads downwards into the tunnels. You jump in, I would suppose, and what is your marching order?
I'm in the middle.
Okay, I go first.
Okay. This is your last.
Yeah.
Okay. The guy who has scent tracking is last. Okay.
All right. Be my guest. Would you like to go first?
Now I'm last.
Now you're last.
Yeah. Okay.
So you stand awkwardly a little bit, and then he goes. He's about to go first, and then he's like, "Oh, I have got scent tracking. I see you. Okay." And then the blood hunter jumps in first, followed by
me.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And as you go down, you're like, "Oh, did you want to go?" And then boom, you go.
Oh wait.
And in that awkward shuffle, you find yourself going in last.
This is the second time today you've moved.
For, well, as we're in the tunnel, I kiss my picture.
Okay. You find that...
I kiss the my wife's...
You find that it's really, really dark.
Oh, wait, the gymnasium. No, they don't have...
No, they don't. I'm a variant human, I don't have...
I forgot.
I'm a variant human.
Are we...
Might anyone have the light contract?
I forgot that I can cast with the
Oh, okay. I asked you a while ago, do you have passed without a trace?
No,
you were
I didn't hear you.
Because I was thinking, wait, Jehudiel has passed without a trace.
Yeah.
Anyway, so...
I take out a torch.
Okay.
You take a torch out.
Did you ask me? Well, I didn't hear you. So I was rolling, so...
Yeah, well, you were rolling, and then when the dice were about to take out, then wait. Don't you have passed without a trace?
I didn't hear you. I didn't read my stuff. I didn't see it.
So your torch lights bright radius and another 20 feet of dim light for an hour. Okay. So
I still have my 4 hours left on me.
Correct. As you move forward, the only source of light being from behind you, I suppose. Let's see. 5, 10.
Cats don't have dark
vision. So actually, you can only see about 20 feet in front of you, and then it becomes dimly lit beyond that.
But can I be aware of
I will light like one torch.
Sure.
Wait,
I
have
as far
a torch.
As you can normally smell. Also hearing.
I also light a torch.
Okay.
Because it's dark.
Okay. All right. Take note of what you're holding. Are you weapon out?
No.
No, okay.
I'm rapier out and torch.
Okay, alright. So,
it may not be a D12, but it is.
You move forward. Go ahead and make a perception check. Fast.
All of us?
No,
okay.
Only fast. Yeah. Wait, does it involve. It doesn't involve smell or feeling.
Okay, so it's just.
That is 16 plus 5. 21?
21.
Okay. I built this new truck. You're about to move forward as you put your foot down, you immediately sense that something's wrong. You take your foot off of the next panel. You see that there is.
I bump into his back.
Oh!
Move zero forward. Go ahead and make this lady save.
Me?
It's not to bump into Bast so that he doesn't put pressure.
I have a zero on dex, 15.
Okay, alright. You maintain your balance.
What's going on?
Bring the walls.
Don't stop pushing. You stop. You stop
me. And then I point where my foot was going to land and say, that shit.
Prestidigitation
can help this situation.
You
can change the taste automatically.
I have I conjure a mage hand and maybe we back off and
it
then
it might be an
pressing.
Alarm trap though. It might,
oh right.
Can we step over it?
It seems large enough that you can jump over it. Can I jump over it and then? Try to figure out a way to get him across because I'm not sure if he can jump.
You
can jump over as well. This is fun.
With the shortest, right? So my blade song goes back.
Okay. What about him? Will he be able to jump over? You guys could easily jump over. Can I discern whether the next spot immediately after that is possible? Depends how far you're going to be jumping. If you just want to jump right across from.
Well, what is it? What is the
brush plate? It's about 5 feet. A running jump should be able to get you across.
Do we have the rule for that?
No.
Okay.
I'm just worried that like after the pressure plate, there's another pressure plate.
Okay.
So we're gonna be screwed over. Get there. What?
Can I make a history check on Arete and trap making? Which I may have researched on prior.
Sure. Right. Can I borrow someone's dagger?
tie a rope to it.
And I'm like, crap! Wait.
It's only a 5. Plus 5, 10.
I have pitons and...
Oh, that's true. Arateans are not known for their trap-making skills. They are absolutely inept.
I think it's safe. You can actually step on that and spy.
I have pitons and
look,
I...
Look, according to my skills... Have,
wait, sorry.
According to my references.
According to my references.
Did you use the rope or did I use the rope?
I used the rope. Well, so I still have 50 feet.
Okay, do you need pitons?
We can try to swim across. But we'd have to discern first what the next one's a pressure plate.
Anyway,
according to my references. Or the thing is a terrible trap makers.
If you want if you want to test that, I say stepping aside, like, give him with
I jump over it.
Yeah. You make a running jump?
Well, apparently the Arathis didn't make it, and maybe the rat people made the traps.
And they're probably
efficient.
Mid-air. you land and nothing happens, and you look
I stare tensely at
a few seconds, and then you see a fraction of an inch, and then nothing happens.
Fuck!
What is that?
Another brush.
I sank.
You sank.
Another pressure plate. God. But nothing happens.
No, it could be a long trap.
Or it could
you
go off.
You hear a faint rumbling from further down the corridor from where you came from.
Okay, I think it might be time to run.
Wait, jump into the sinking?
I read a book before about Mr. Jones running from a giant.
You hear a million skittering noises.
Different book.
I think it's time to run.
Jump and I attempt to jump over the sinking?
You would have to jump twice as far.
No, he's not.
What
if there's a third pressure plate?
Damn it.
He's not.
It's always the third one that gets him.
He's not sinking lower. He just triggered another pressure plate. It's not quicksand. It's not quicksand.
Oh, I thought it was quicksand.
Okay.
I run torch out with my rapier in the other.
Okay. So, terrible trap makers, huh?
It was a Skaven, I swear.
I like how
I studied our Cogrons, not Skaven.
I like how it only occurs to you that the rat people might... Oh shit!
The funny thing is, it was in character.
I mean,
our character. Oh yeah, Skaven, right. They live here now, right?
The rat people could have made the traps mature.
Okay, so... you hear.
Oh, so we're running now?
Yeah, you're running, okay. And then you hear skittering noises.
Run, lads, run!
And then a faint.
Oh.
The corridor begins to widen out, and you find yourself much. Have you seen Lord of the Rings when you break up suddenly into this gigantic hall with humongous pillars? Break into that, and where your light is a tiny fraction of the entire room.
Is there look like there's any place to hide?
Son of a fuck!
You see, however, Arathean lore on the.
Wait, wait!
take notes!
Learn later! Rats first!
My wife would have loved to see this single tear! Oh, Elena, if you could have been alive to see this.
I take another torch and throw it behind us. And
okay.
We run back. We're running.
Alright. So
fuck!
As you're running, you're scribbling notes. You see your torch briefly light up a swarm of rats as they cover it and engulf it. Out of the tunnel that you had come from, steps holding the top of the tunnel wall. Steps. So what appears to be
huge.
Please don't say retro.
Huge.
It's about. Please don't say retro. It's about the size of an ogre. Shit.
Ogre size.
A rat ogre.
It's kind of dark. Oh,
fuck.
Okay. The picture's kind of dark.
So, pressure plates, huh?
How do you make the screen right there?
My honesty and knowledge did not fail us. It was the knowledge of those goddamn skills.
Oh. Oh, sorry. Sorry.
Yeah, I see it. I see it.
Okay. It is the size of an ogre. Literally the size of an ogre.
Wait, is it 8 feet?
It goes... And it runs on all four. And through it all, rats, the swarm is keeping up with it. Many of them are getting squished under its claws. If you have something that explodes or catches fire...
I have something that catches fire!
To take care of the rats, I would appreciate it.
I have a torch.
We can't light the swarm of rats on fire with the single torch.
Does anyone have oil?
Alright, I'll
grab something in the kitchen.
I didn't think we'd be fighting rats!
Would my mess kit have cooking oil in it?
A very small pump. Enough to cook. You could fry a chicken. Or a rat.
Or a rat.
A singular. And not a very big one.
I could kill one rat with my mighty cooking oil.
I have fire magic and no, this
initiative
pack doesn't have the...
That's just
this doesn't have the oil.
We're dead. Not even gonna think about it, we're dead.
Which one has the...
Place yourselves in running order. Running march order.
Wait, first. I forgot who got...
No, he's first now.
He's first.
You went first!
Now who goes next? I don't know.
I think it's like that. I think.
You went before he did.
Did I?
Yes, you
before
did.
Before he did?
Yes, you jumped in, remember? And then did you want to? And then you
No, but then remember when he ran ahead? He ran ahead, stepped on the pressure plate.
All right, that's correct.
Yeah.
Oh, in that case, you would be ahead.
Yeah, he... This is...
Bast.
There you go.
It's Professor Bast.
Oh, God.
I think he fits right in mind, Paul.
Oh, totally.
Totally.
Except he's really smart.
Book smart.
Oh, Mayor's book smart. Oh, wait, no, not that one. This thing, I saw one.
It's a thing.
There we go. That's.
I think Dingleton would feel competitive with all the knowledge checks. Or...
And I think, Mayor went to full. We'll say that this represents a swarm of rats.
Wait. Oh my.
Two collective swarms of rats.
Oh my god. Oh, and you have the dancing thing. Bingleton will totally...
You can't pull it off. I'm the only one who can pull it off. And I'm human.
He is the...
Do what?
Dancing.
Oh, magical dancing, yes. However, actual dancing.
No.
Are you trained in performance, sir?
I am, in fact, trained in performance.
What's your
performance? Plus one.
Nice. I'm plus seven.
Yes, he's grand
jitters. I don't charisma for this guy.
Yeah. You take this, fucker. Huh. All right. Since Harvey gets back. But we're on Lysander first, actually. So, Lysander, you can go ahead.
We're fighting? Are we really fighting?
Wait, there's a... That sounds familiar.
Fighting? Is it from Harry Potter or something?
I don't know. Anyway, go ahead. Swarms can occupy your space, and you can occupy a swarm space as well.
I am gonna... I am a casting machine! I have no more spells left for shield, but let's burn these bitches to the ground.
Burning hands.
I'm gonna cast Burning Hands.
Oh.
15-foot cone. So I move. I don't want to go in base contact with him, so I can all still run away.
Sure.
Here. Where would the 15-foot cone?
However you want to orient it.
I want to just.
So
straight.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah, that'll hit everything.
That'll hit everything.
Yeah.
Nice. And so that is 3d6 fire damage, and is that dexterity saving throw?
Your DC is.
My DC is only 12. Oh, not very good rules. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 only.
9! 9!
we have run with the, you know,
10%. I hold my arcane focus and like how Rekka writes characters to summon the dragons, I do a few gestures with my hands and I cast Burning Hands. With only one hand, so it's Burning Hand.
Okay, alright. You create a symbol in the air,
mm-hmm.
and it burns in flame. You deal 9 fire damage
to whoever fails. And it's half damage on a successful save.
Temporary. Is that temporary? Is that
just me?
No.
I don't know.
Okay, so.
I move back.
Alright.
Because I don't want to get.
Okay. You turn around, you quickly write several runes in the air, and they begin to glow. You recognize this immediately as a preemptive fire, the Burning Hands. And flame bursts out from his hand. He lays down.
And I am out of
spell. A literal line of fire. Flame, basically casting like a flamethrower above everything. A various squealing. So many rats dying. The smell of burnt flesh everywhere. Even the rat was almost nightmare.
Yeah.
We now go to Bast.
Oh, is that it? We still have like an action search if you want to.
I think
I'm gonna attack the roger. Okay, you're gonna go up.
Mm-hmm. Are you shifting?
No, not yet. 1, 2, 3.
All right, I'm holding my rapier. Oh, sorry, I dropped the torch.
Okay.
You can
go ahead and put a d12 where you drop your torches. D12, a d4.
I would say here.
It's my
stuff.
I want
to.
We got a shit ton of
D4s
on.
But let's use the yellow one
because
it's fire.
Alright. Should I roll my attack?
Yeah, go.
Both attacks?
Mm-hmm.
That's a 23 and a 20.
Yes.
Both gonna hit.
Nothing.
So.
Yes. Yeah,
doesn't tell me much about it. So 2d4s. Because that's one for magic, one for the silver dagger, and then.
One of them is blood rite, right?
Yeah. So, do I still roll the d8 for the steel save? Not for the steel rapier. Despite the fact that I know if this is where Rat Ogre is, that he might be immune to it.
No. You can certainly tell it's not a were rat.
Okay.
It's just a rat ogre of a possible sub race of.
Do you know that? Never mind.
No, but you know your were rats, and that's not a were rat.
Okay.
But do we know that it's not aware?
Oh,
no.
Sorry, that's a D10, not a D8. So that's 12.
Nice.
13, 14. What'd you roll in the D8?
8.
You haven't transformed.
Oh, yeah, sure.
8. So it's 11. It's 11 plus 1, 12, and then the other one does 3 damage. Because it has the magic damage.
So you hit with 11 total on the steel, and then on the dagger,
it's 2 plus 3, so
5. Plus 3, 5.
So did you, wait, a D4. D4. Didn't you roll 2D4s because you're in a blood rite?
Yeah, but remember, I enchanted the rapier.
Steel rapier.
Oh, okay, so the 11 was inclusive
yes.
of the blood rite.
Mm-hmm. Got it. I made it so that if worst comes to worst, all of us have a weapon that we can attack with.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tell me how your attacks go.
Realizing that if we don't take this thing out, we're not going to be able to find this cave in. Without being accosted by multiple parties. I sport and joke onto it. I drive, with sparks coming off of my rapier, I try to drive it into the creature's hide, and then I bring up the dagger into the side of its head, and I attempt to jab it into the side of its head.
Okay. Both stay true, but you sense that
the creature's skull is so thick that even you're able to get the complete blade of the dagger's inwards. It's going to take a lot more than that to take it down. It peels you off of its face, throwing you onto the ground, and then comes up with a slash of its humongous hand about the size of half your body.
I call out as a free action. You can use your axe. It's not a wear axe.
Okay. Damn it. So I have to drop it and so I can shoot it.
My AC is 16.
Okay, alright. We now go to Professor Ashford.
Dr. Okay. Professor Ashford.
Dr. Professor Ashford.
PhD. I start my blade singing.
Okay.
And
Your balls drop? Okay.
Yeah. At the same time I drop the bass,
I also drop my torch. Alright. Okay.
I move here. And I will cast Ice Knife. If I cast it here, it doesn't hit him, right?
Like, if you try and attack a point behind him.
I mean,
what's the range?
My aim is to hit him, but not hit him with the Ice Knife.
As he is one solid creature, I'm going to say that it's going to hit the first point of impact. Unless you're trying to hit from a point behind him. Because he's like a thick. Like, you wouldn't be able to hit his back if you were facing him.
In that case, I will... There, and... hit these clusters of rats instead, and try to hit him along with it.
Okay.
Or, from this angle, can I hit the side and not, like, this area of the side?
Okay, sure.
Alright. It won't hit him. See what Ice Knife does for me.
I believe the initial damage, the piercing damage, only hits if it hits or misses.
Yeah.
But the blast will
2d6 and this
will do even and a half. Oh no, it's,
I think it's 1d10 for the Ice Knife itself and 2d6 for the area effect.
Yes.
No.
But I believe that the area effect can still be dodged, right?
It's the dex save.
But it doesn't do half on this.
It does half?
No, it doesn't.
Oh.
Because it's very cheap. It does a lot of damage.
I'm gonna try and hit the guy with Ice Knife. Oh, god damn it.
No.
Luck.
Oh, are you saving it for which bolt?
Yeah, sure. I'll use luck on this one. That's better. That's a 17. Because it's a 12. So it's plus 5. 17 on the Ice Knife.
Okay, that'll hit.
Yes.
Yes. That's a D10. Where is my D10?
D10 piercing, and then it explodes.
Mm-hmm.
Then everything within 5 feet.
It's 3 damage on him.
So 3 piercing damage.
And exploding damage is...
Oh.
5, 7.
Tell me how that attack goes.
So, does it have a material component to it? Can you just check? Yes. But, okay. So, using my free hand, I take out my arcane focus, which is a tuft of hair, my hair. And as I'm blade dancing, I slide the hair, creating this ice-like blade on it, and then I chuck the blade onto that guy, and as it hits, it blows up into different ice spikes.
Yeah, it pierces the ogre first, and it explodes, spraying ice everywhere. How much damage did your
explosion? 7.
Explosion do?
7. Assuming the
7 cold damage?
Yes, it's cold damage.
Okay. As it explodes outwards, the ogre takes cover behind his own hide, and he manages to deflect the most of it upon his thicker hide. However, the rat swarm beside him takes the damage completely, wiping out maybe half of the horde.
Yes.
Combined with the amount of damage that this part of the horde apparently took, also the full brunt of.
Burning hands.
So, what
Lysander cut in half, you cut in half once more. This horde is significantly reduced.
This one here?
Yes.
On its right?
Yes, let's say that is...
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, now how do we...
We are now...
I don't have any...
Now focus fire, gentlemen. On the big thing. Make sure it does not get to my face.
This rat swarm will swarm over.
Oh god.
Swarm into his space.
Well, how, what happens if it goes to your space? Do you have disadvantage or something?
No. Tries to eat you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. It will make an attack against him. He has not transformed, so I believe his AC is a 16. This second swarm will swarm forward. Some of it will take him. It will extinguish this torch.
Ah, damn it. Oh no, it's dark.
Some of it will... They will overlap as well, taking it to you.
I'm in dim light, right?
Many of the rats attack Lysander. Unfortunately, that's only a 9 hit. So you manage to pop up and just sort of bat them away from your feet. Trying to keep them from completely engulfing you. We go back up to Lysander.
Me? What happens if I try to stab?
You can.
There's
an opportunity attack if you keep going though. I consider them difficult terrain.
Keep
going.
Because they're rats.
Well, they're swarming and attacking me as well.
How do?
But if you go that way, that's nothing. That's just 5 feet.
Ah,
if
okay.
You take another step, that's not true.
Ah, okay. Then I'll step over here.
You can step on that sword.
Well, will I get an opportunity attack if I go here? Or is it...
The swarm is still
okay, so but I will attack. I
ogre side.
I'm here, right? So I drop the rapier there.
Yeah.
Because he said I can use my axe. And as I'm running, I achieve. What?
No,
because I can't sheath and unsheath. And I will attack with my axe.
After his battle, let's buy snaps.
Sure.
And order the food.
You made your back, by the way.
Let's order.
21.
That'll hit. 8,
9, 10, 11 damage.
Okay.
So I run up and as I'm shooting it, I take a big swing at Rat Ogre.
You take a humongous slice across you. It's dripping blood, oozing and matting its fur. It is highly satisfying to finally hit with something meaty again. It is
rapier schmapier. Oh, I dropped the thing.
Hey.
Bass, hey. We're on you.
Chef is a bonus action.
Where's... Oh, here.
Moon Prism Power!
with a process. Oh yeah, it's like that.
Not 20.
Is it? Yeah.
So
I just guessed based on the reaction.
Uh-huh.
It was a 1, actually. 1.
So 2d8 plus d4 and then all of this plus 4.
This is with your right damage? You right. Double the right damage as well.
So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
More caliente.
Is it a singular strike or do you make multiple?
I want
I want to make two strikes with the steel rapier. And then mortality is clarified with a single strike.
Hope.
Yeah.
Hope
fire. Blossoms.
Hope blossoms.
Hope blossoms as the enemy crumbles.
As the enemy crumbles. You take very precise shots. And as you do, you slip one just underneath his chin, and then you a little bit of electricity surges through your body, your sword, channeling up through the rapier into the bottom. A chunk of meat falls off from its face as it flops to the ground, wagging a little bit. You know that it might be it might have bitten off the end of its own tongue. You go now too.
Right.
It is now going to try even things out upon you, Bast. The source of all of its fury. 25 to hit. That's a hit.
Wow.
Shield. Not even that.
Not even the shield.
I could. It's possible, like, if Flower Me, I could use luck on that. And then she.
Oh, can you impose.
Wait, I'm...
Can you impose luck on others?
Yeah. I can impose luck on an attack against me.
Ah.
And choose which dice to take.
Ah, okay.
Oh!
I'm curious. Is there a feat that allows. There's a feat that allows you to get a spell, a cantrip.
Oh, what?
Oh, no, it is a cantrip.
He slams his hand right down the top of you, dealing. 12 bludgeoning damage.
Oh gods! It's more than half.
Bring you down to 9.
Oh gods, are you below your...
Yep.
Are you well?
First meat!
And it seems to be holding you down and... it screams, it's in your face, it's breath. Horrendous upon... a horrendous wind. You now go to...
With my last conscious thought.
Oh, you're not dead.
No, I mean like before the thing takes over.
Is it going to take over?
At the DC 15.
Yeah, it's now a DC 15.
If I move here, am I considered disadvantage?
Why would you be? Oh, because you are away from the torch. No. Is it? Oh.
That is the torch.
That's bright light. Right. Bright light is 5, 10, 15, 20. Dim light is 5'10". Dim light has no effect on attack rolls.
Oh, okay. So I pick this up and I duel. That does not. Well, how would you rule this? It says here on blades.
Yeah, it's a rapier.
It ends early if you are incapacitated, dawn heavy or dawn medium or heavy, or if you use two hands to make an attack with a weapon.
However, that's two rapiers and you...
Oh yeah, I don't have that feat.
It's on that.
Move here for a clear shot.
Burn!
Attack rolls.
But that's a second level spell slot. I will use Witch.
Okay, here you go. Oh, you can... Or if you use Witch Bolt on a second level, then you roll 2d12s.
You need heavier dice.
No, he needs better luck. Which he does.
Which
in mechanical
does.
Form.
That's better. 19
plus
much
learned
5.
I've learned to put as much into passive bonuses as possible. So that when I make my dice roll, no matter how shit the roll is, I still have a decent chance.
With
12. Wow!
Wow!
Boom! Motherfucker!
Boom, bitch! Tell me how that attack goes.
As I'm dancing around, I
prancing.
I use the tuft of my arcane focus, which is the tuft of my hair, and put my sword in lightning.
It singes a little bit. Before it singes my hair. An arc of lightning cracks across the room. Kakoom! As it strikes into the shoulder of the rattle. The force of the blow nearly knocks it completely over, but it regains its ground.
And then
it's smoking.
I'm trying to maintain that lightning. This is
Abaracadabra!
It's still 30 feet. I will move 1, 2.
Alright.
Now I'm concentrating.
I call out to you and say, be careful of me. Back off! If you can.
You can see him stopping.
How many of those do you get today?
Three. That could go well with a halfling.
Can we take an hour's rest after this?
And then you get luck.
The first rat swarm below you will try to nibble at your heels. However, you do manage to fend most of them off because Nori rolls a 7 hit. The second rat swarm, though, will reorient itself.
Like, do we get... Oh, no! Oh, no, the rapier! No. I'm sorry! But does it...
Just short of you.
So the rapier's still there.
It's not like they can pull it out.
Okay. I thought they were going to steal it.
Yeah, they pocketed it.
How?
In rat pockets. God, why did you drop it?
You could have, like, sheathed it.
Yeah, but then I can't take out... I only have one interaction.
It will, however, use its attack to... They sense as this blood continues to drip on the ground, it feeds their frenzy.
Vile vermins!
Very vile vermin.
Huh?
Very vile vermin.
Beautiful look.
19.
Shit!
What?
19 to hit.
Oh, we don't have.
Wait, the shield. Work on someone else. I will.
No.
it's
specified.
Damn it.
I thought I could save your ass.
Oh god. Okay. It deals exactly 9 damage.
You're down?
You're down?
They swarm above him, leaping one on top of the other.
Fight!
And eventually
fight, lad! Fight!
He gets buried underneath the...
Oh god.
Do you not have a potion on you?
I have a potion on me.
You would have to stick your hand into the... ground to feed
him. But
we go
the
up to Lysander.
That's
you have your action surge, I believe, so I don't think it affects you too much.
No. Like, where?
What's planning for Saros Ashford to be a little more serious today?
Well, you're missing Mindhoff a lot. And you're gonna miss it a lot more because it's gonna be. Because since we moved Mindhoff back.
Yeah, we're playing FF8 on that day.
So we're. We're gonna continue to feel this bleed through for a while.
Did they tell you about
attack the Red Hooker?
Yeah.
21?
I've learned that lesson.
That's gonna hit.
No, did they tell you about the future of Mindhoff?
Oh no.
13,
14.
Oh god.
You come in
with your great axe underneath its throat.
And then the floor.
It's still
there. Its throat is bleeding out of body.
Motherfucker, still alive!
It holds its throat, but it's barely there. It still stands before you.
I will action surge and...
Do you have it healed yet?
Huh?
Oh, I thought you were healing him. Oh, never mind.
I will surge and...
Using a reaction to pull the potion and action speed it.
Does he look really... How bad does he look?
You feel that Ashford's... lightning might kill him the next day.
Okay, then fine. I will heal.
And it's a 1.
I'll pick my potion.
That's true. It could be a 1.
Yeah, it could be a 1. And
I tried.
But come to think of it, which bog gets really strong as it scales?
Yeah, it's
Zara.
Fuck.
You remember Zara? Holy crap. Zara is my target for my target state for Elder Sniper.
Oh yeah, that would be good.
I will heal.
Oh god.
But then
who's next?
If I heal him and then he gets I don't remember the initiative anymore.
Bass will come next.
Okay.
My recipe. Oh, what's this? Oh, thank
four.
You.
Is it 2d4 plus 2?
Thank you.
2d4 plus... Is it 2d4 plus 2? 2, 4, 5, 6. So after I slash at the rat ogre, I take out the potion and... And I force feed the potion while swatting some rats away.
You move.
you move very fast.
No, from complete unconsciousness.
Good. You are suddenly rudely awakened.
Wait, how much did you heal me?
Six. Okay. Six only.
I just gotta check if you maintain your transformation to the minute that you're unconscious.
When
you got knocked over, as she brushes the rats away to feed you your potion, she finds that you are completely knocked over.
Okay.
Where'd
that
food
go?
It's your turn.
Is my ripper still attached?
No, you drop anything you hold, but it's right beside you.
Shit, so the enchantment's off.
Well, it was off already when you got unconscious.
I attack with it. I stand up with my movement.
You pick up.
As my interaction, I pick up my rapier and I make the attack.
6, 18.
So fine.
That hit.
So eight.
Aww.
you get yourself right off your feet. You do the standard heroic leap upon your feet without using your hands. And then you pierce the rat ogre straight into the heart with your rapier. And as you pull it forth, the ogre finally moves. Falls flat on the ground.
Does he? Oh, finally.
We go to Professor Action.
Oh, man. Can you move your target?
Well, no. Professor Action is now, if you can chain lightning the rats, much appreciated.
Oh, you can't move targets with...
One D with Scorch. I'm going to use Sword Burst. I'm going to say where I am. I'm going to use Sword Burst. Deck save. If they fail, this is 1d6.
Read out Swordburst.
Oh, sure. I create a momentary circle of spectral blades that sweep around me. Each creature within range other than you must succeed on a dexterity saving throw or take 1d6 force damage.
What, so I have to make a dex saving throw too?
No, you're not in range.
What's the range?
Just my area.
Okay.
Swordburst. This is Sevard's move.
Oh, okay. What's your DC?
13.
Dexterity?
Uh-huh.
Is there half damage and fail?
Nope, it's cancer.
Okay. As you burst away, you knock away, you straight up kill a few rats, but it's not near plenty enough
to
diminish this the horde.
I dance harder.
Okay. Your form starts to suffer a little bit given the hardness with your. You start to hear rave music.
What is love?
Yeah. Strangely, my head keeps popping.
Fuck, we consume those sandwiches like it was nothing. Mm-hmm. We consume those sandwiches in one round.
Yeah. You forgot to buy snacks to come. One attack will go up against Lysander. Only 8 to hit.
Yeah, miss.
One will go up on Professor Ashford.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Only an 11 to hit.
Okay.
Woo! Woo! Are you both? Are any of you badly damaged?
No, I'm at 18.
No.
We go up to Lysander.
Huh?
I'm the only one who ate it.
Pretty much.
I don't know why I didn't do this before.
This is a good example of.
I will activate Green Flame Blade.
Oh,
I don't know why I didn't do that before.
Why the fuck did I do that a while ago?
I don't know, I also forgot. Oh, I always keep forgetting this magic thing. So I will... I will just hack away at the rat swarm.
Sure, that's already two within your reach anyway. So okay. One will lead to the other. Which one will you attack? The smaller one or the bigger one?
I go for... Wait.
It's only one will take the full...
Yeah, one will take your weapon damage and the other will take the leaping fire damage.
This one?
You'll attack that one.
Yeah, this one. What? Yeah.
this bursts into flame.
As you do note that with your great axe, your attack will be diminished damage because there's so many of them.
Oh! Oh, okay, fine. Nine.
They're not very hard to hit, but that just didn't hit.
Shit.
You slash downwards blindly. Rats are just screeching out of your waist. A couple of rats fly here and there.
Fuck you!
What kind of action is
that? That one was rat. That one was Ratovich.
Oh, the rest of them.
Squeakovich.
Squeakovich. Okay, we go now to Bast.
What kind of action?
A bastion.
I'm capable of
bastion.
Activating the blood red in combat.
You are as a. Bonus action. Bonus action.
I use my bonus action to activate the blood rite.
Okay.
Of this time fire. Burn it with fire. Then I use my rapier to attack.
What did I tell?
Hey, lightning was cool at the start.
Actually, you can only choose to learn one of the primal rites. So the fact that you already use lightning means that you use lightning all the time.
Okay, then I empower you with lightning.
Oh!
17
plus
5.
Oh, yeah,
you
have my cane recovery.
So, 17 plus 5, so 22.
You already used your cane recovery? Oh, because it's once per...
So do you roll those dice separately? Just so that we can choose, we can see which ones get half?
Sure, sure.
Good thing scorching you.
That's a D8.
Oh, yeah. But
add your modifier.
That's fine.
That's 7.
No, 6 plus 3, 9. So you'll deal 4 piercing damage, and then you can roll your blood rate as well.
So which did you attack the one right below you?
Yeah.
So that is a 1 damage.
Okay. The additional 1 lightning damage. So you strike out as many as you can. Your arm is a blur, so you just hack away, slashing, piercing. Stabbing at every rat that comes near you. You're beginning to really diminish this whole the swarm beneath you.
I then use my interaction to pick up the dagger which is on the floor.
Okay.
And then a free action to scream, "Can someone please pick up my other rapier? It was expensive to make."
Okay, okay.
It's a sword.
I'm quite busy right now.
That's it. Okay. We now go to
the
service.
Professor.
Cyrus will cast.
I'm only a professor.
Let me see. On a hit, the target suffers attacks and green fire lips the leaves from the target to a different creature of your choice you
correct.
Can see within 5 feet of it.
Of the creature. Yes.
So it can leap if I hit this.
Correct.
Alright, green flame blade it is now.
So you do half damage in this hit because it's the weapon damage.
Is it?
Yes. Because all of the normal effects of the attack occur as normal.
Is it because there
because
are
it's
rats
a weapon?
Oh.
What?
Yeah, you're asking why it will do half damage?
Yeah.
Because you will make a... You're doing using Green Flame Blade?
Yeah.
So the Green Flame Blade you will attack with your normal weapon damage, and then the fire will leave. The fire will not do will not.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The fire will only take 3 damage.
Yeah, so the fire will not be split in half, but your normal weapon damage will do.
Yeah.
Well, why will it be?
Because it's a swarm.
Oh, because it's a swarm. It's easy.
That's a 12 plus 5. 17?
17.
That is a D8. 1 divided by 2 is still 1.
That's correct.
Wait, it's still, that's a 4 actually. So
yeah, it's still have your
modifier.
Your modifier.
And the other thing takes 3 damage.
With your rapier, you move your hand almost as fast as you try to pierce the rats everywhere.
As I'm dancing.
Yeah. You hear music in your head, and then as you pierce one, you pierce it with such force it gets flipped up in the air, and the rat tail grazes you.
You sons of fucks!
Fire leaps from you, immolating the swarm below Bast, and it gets completely wiped out.
That's what you get! For taking my face.
Yeah.
You other swarm. That's what you get for this swarm.
Now,
take vengeance for my face.
He says wiping his face up with his leg.
The rat swarm will try to overwhelm you, Professor.
They want your face.
Professor.
That's only a 13 to hit.
Okay. That would have hit me if I didn't have mage armor and if I didn't have singing.
Okay. We go up to Lysander.
What?
Lysander. roll?
Blade Singing adds my intelligence modifier to my AC.
Oh, okay.
The max health, by the way, is now at 19.
I will attack the one below me.
No, it dissipated before, so it's still at 22 now.
Wait,
no,
if
I recast it.
If I step.
Yes, but it when you lose the blood, right, your max goes back up.
Oh, yeah.
Hmm? If I step over here, does it have a point?
No.
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 7 plus 5, 12.
That'll hit.
Okay. Oh, it hits. I forgot. Never mind. I forgot to do the green flame date thing.
Oh, there's nobody for it to leap on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow!
Oh,
full damage again!
15.
Bam.
15.
Holy. Your D12 streak, you're right.
Yeah.
7. So you get 7. Slash.
Okay, 7, yeah.
Okay, so you slash away at the horde, chopping through it.
Vermins!
You managed to reduce their. You managed to reduce their numbers.
Nice.
Yeah.
There. I see that fucker. He's right there.
What? Which one? What happened?
Can't you see? It's that one, the smiling one.
It's the
smiling
smile.
One.
We go too fast.
What did the rat do?
Yeah. The rat that touched his face is already dead. He's imagining things like this.
I'm enraged. Which I actually am. Yeah, it's Blink Song.
it's some sort of magical rage.
Your modifier. So what's a 3? What's an 8 plus 3? Plus 3? 8, 9, 10, 11. 11. So you'll deal 5 damage
and then
piercing. And then you'll deal your extra right damage.
3.
8. So you deal 8 damage total.
Okay.
You reduce it even further. As your electricity arcs, every rat that you pierce, electricity arcs hitting another rat. To the point that you're starting to clear out an entire space, a swath of rats before you. You now go to Professor Ash.
Professor!
Our lesson for today? If pressure points are anywhere near,
just gonna attack it.
We be careful.
That is a 9 plus 5. 40. That's it. 5 plus 3, 8 over 2, 4 damage.
4. Okay. You managed to reduce it just to barely a handful of rats.
There's
a square here.
That's wood.
So you managed to reduce it to just a handful of rats before.
In front of me,
you,
in front of them.
In front of them, I'd say. Because since it was your attack that wiped out the rats on your side.
Vengeance.
One seems to still be swimming.
Snickering.
In your head, it's snickering. In fact, that single rat was dead the moment it touched your face. It was the force of your blow that knocked it up in the first place, anyway.
Oh, dead rat. I'll find you.
The remaining rat
must die.
The remaining rats make a... just mindlessly throw themselves at Bast.
Wow.
Fuck, if this actually hits.
15 hit.
Yes. Oh, shit.
That almost hit.
Oh, it almost hits.
And then we
good
go...
job doing the tank. The job of...
Why am I tank?
I don't know. I'm right there.
You have the highest AC actually
when I'm shifted. Yeah.
When you're shifted, other than placing it. And you have the second highest hit die, so you would be the tankiest.
What's your AC when you shift?
17.
Oh, me
17.
Too. That's 17. 8, 9, 10.
The thing is, I present
13?
I present
13?
13. That'll hit.
Oh wow, full damage again.
It's on its side, unfortunately.
Oh, shit.
Is it?
Yeah, it's on its side. Oh!
It's still full damage.
Still full damage.
That's... what?
15.
So
what is
all? You just take a look at this.
So lucky.
You take a look at the remaining.
The vermin.
Even out your swing, and then... boom! Just one harvesting side.
If
you've ever played Fruit Ninja, this is nothing like it.
Okay,
you
the rat swarm just there. Whatever rats were remaining just scurry off.
Finally.
And the sentient, the malevolent sentience of that horde of rats just dissipates.
Finally.
You find yourself once again completely silent.
I get the silver rapier. Right. I sheathe it.
I take my torch.
Your one torch is remaining. The other one is on the floor. You find it, but it's extinguished.
Okay, I guess I light another one.
No, you can go ahead and light the existing one.
Mm-hmm.
You can go ahead and light the existing one. You don't have to spend.
Okay.
Do you have a tinder box?
Yeah. So, okay.
We'll take a break here.
Are you taking a break?
Can I heal myself? Are you taking a short rest as well?
Yes.
Might I suggest a long
rest? Oh,
I'm gonna D10 and potion.
I don't mind a long rest.
Taking a short rest or long rest before we end?
Might I suggest a long rest?
We're camping here?
I'm still not done with my blades.
You're gonna take a long rest, also decide the shifts.
I will take first shift.
I would suggest before we
dancing.
Do any of this, we go back out and then camp out with the article for outside.
We've gone so far.
It's a significant distance. Okay, never mind then. Sure, let's go.
I have a bedroll.
So do I.
Oh, wait.
So we're taking a long rest?
Yeah.
I don't have a bedroll.
I'll restore later if ever we rest unmolested.
I will take second shift.
Right.
Is it fine? Is it fine?
Yeah, okay.
So how many each would that be? 8.
6 hours still.
Three.
Well, 8 divided by 3, about 2.5 hours.
Okay.
Alright, we can end there. Don't restore any hit points in case something happens.